down to places, found interesting faces, whether young or old, no one left out in the cold. Take a long look around in places of renown, no one would wear a frown. And everybody got on down, sang a song or played along. The people that we meet came right up off the street. With a song and a dance, we gave everyone a chance. Yeah, we gave everyone a chance.
I'll see you when you get there, if you ever get there.
We'll see you when you get there, meet you when you get there. We really care and want to share some time with you. We'll meet you and greet you. We don't want to compete, we're like a team. Sometimes a dream come true. Everybody gets a chance to do what they really want to do. Yeah, what they really want to do.
Oh, at the back, finally fucking nailed it. Taking about 3-4 weeks to get there, but I've smashed the intro. All right, one and all. Nice to see you, Alex Takeover. How you doing, mate? All right, Merry Midnight. All right, don't call me dickbag. All right, Craig. All right, Cactus Jacku. All right, Big Cod Roger. Always struggle with that name. All right, TJ Wolster. All right, Vile. Nice to see you. All right, Jack Tribe. All right, PJ the Oz. All right, Best Boy Patrick. All right, all right, all right. Who died today? What does that mean? What, because I'm wearing black? It's just a black sweatshirt. What are you on about? Loads of people have died today. Let's not talk about that. We're here to have some fun before I fuck off for a week and leave all you sad cunts on your lonesomes, eh? Is everybody looking forward to a great night of family entertainment here on Cunts? On the show tonight. On the show. On the... That's my head in. People on the show. It's not a show. I'm sat in the box room in front of two doors. On the magnificent television program you're watching tonight, we're going to be watching Wife Swap. We're going to be watching Brucey's Price is Right. And we're going to be watching Season 4 of The Armstrongs. I'm in a great mood tonight. I hope you're all in a great mood. Tell me about your weekends. Fill me in. I'd love to hear. I really, really would. Let me know what you've been up to. Adam, what are you microwaving tonight? Or micro-aving tonight? Nothing. That was a one-off thing. That's not a regular segment on the show. I just wanted to show you. It was a shit segment. We all know it was fucking rubbish. It was boring. Wasn't interesting at all. Went to the football and we won. Well done, El Presidente. Thoughts on the Pringle fanfic? I don't know what that is. I assume that's an Andrew thing. Had a cheeky wank. Lovely. True Mexican. Enjoy. Worked my last ever Saturday night. Mon the boys. Mon the boys to you too. The footy was on and it was lovely. Good. Been drunk since Friday. It's now Tuesday. That's 5 days. Well done. Good lad, I think. Getting a Becky Lemon shirt for your birthday? Fuck off, Spud Gun, you old cunt. Bring up microwave? Nope. I got fired, but that means I'm able to watch cunt again, so silver linings and all. Congratulations on your firing. That's wonderful news. I'm glad that you can be here once again, Poison, because we all missed you. Where'd you get fired from? What happened? What happened? That's really tremendous news. I'm very, very happy to hear it, obviously. Anything else? Did we watch Beauty and the Geek, or am I misremembering? I think you're misremembering. Anyway, Aussie version is officially on YouTube, and we should watch it in the future. Don't want to hear it. It's British TV, except for 1 week a week, 1 week a year, 1 week a year, if I remember. I got offered a new job and start next Monday, which is fun. You've probably had Poison's job, haven't you? Congratulations, Ryan, and congratulations, Poison. They found a really great replacement there in Ryan. He's a great guy. Great guy. It was just a local supermarket. Local to Ryan too. He's going to absolutely smash it. We all know he is. Sorry to hear it, Poison. I'm obviously joking. Sorry to hear you got sacked. There's plenty more local supermarkets in the sea, as the old saying goes. If he was a BrewDog manager, then sorry, lad, I've got your job. You're a BrewDog manager? That's cool. Can you get me some stocks? You all get stocks, don't you? You get shares in the company. Can you give me some of those? Or just some Elvis juice. I quite like that Elvis juice as well. I like all of their drinks, actually. I know the owners are bastards, and you can't comment on it, obviously. I know they're a pair of tossers. Especially one of them. I can't remember his name. Bit like Weatherspoons, isn't it? Yeah, but it's fancy. It's fancy, isn't it? There's like the good beer and hanging lights, like with those old style light bulbs in them, the cool light bulbs. So it's way better than Weatherspoons. I'm actually kind of buzzing about it. It was a shit environment. Oh, I'm glad to hear that, mate. I genuinely am. Aren't we all tossers, really? That's a very, very deep of you, Emmett. We are, sure, all tossers. Absolutely. Guest ales and draft piss pints. I like Weatherspoon's range of beer as well. I don't think you can go wrong with the Weatherspoons. Again, owner's a cunt. Goes without saying. Can't be asked to talk about that. But Shipyard, beautiful beer. Really, really like it. It's on tap everywhere. I think they've got a nice range of guest ales. I don't think they do much wrong, to be honest. The food, you know what you're getting. It's fine. Totally fine. What do you expect for like £7 for some scampi and chips? Adam, why you look homeless? Thank you. Good to see you here, Faris Gaming. It's because I haven't shaved in a while. But the problem with that observation is the fact that I am clearly in a home because of two doors behind me, which are both in my home. So, well done. Big up the Liberty Bound spoons. Big up the Liberty... I don't know what that means. Don't know what that means at all. The beard looks nice. Thank you. Cheers, Adam Perfetti. That's lovely. Appreciate it. Thank you very much for the hype train, by the way. A few people seem to have misunderstood what I said last week, weren't listening, apparently. I am streaming today, as you can tell, because I'm sat here streaming. This is live right now. There's perhaps a 3 second delay, but it is 8:07 in the evening, British summertime right now. I am here. This is indeed live. This is not a pre-record. Next week I'm off. Next week I'm off. So we're going to take a little bit of a break, and then we'll get back to the Armstrongs and all of your regular cunt goodness. As soon as I'm back on the 29th. I'll see you on the 29th. Two whole weeks almost without me. What are you going to do? Not easy, is it? 8:07, time traveler. I meant 18. It's 7:07. Fuck that up. It is 6:08 p.m. BST. All right? It's not a pre-record. And you're not going to fucking let up on that now, are you? Right, I'm taking this off. Bit toasty, isn't it? Even though it's pissing down outside. Weather chat. Great. Hello. Can you get 30 gift subs and 30,000 bits? I doubt it. That, what a lovely, lovely man he was. Coming into Sam's stream last Thursday. And Sam mentioned this himself, so I'm comfortable saying it. But Sam had a bit of a shit day, right? And it absolutely made his day. He was welling up. Stealing my gimmick of crying. No, it was really nice. It was so very, very kind of that. Come on, show your areolas, Adam. No, not gonna do that, unfortunately. Every comment he reads is AI. That'll be the way soon, won't it? I'm not gonna get into AI again. I'm not gonna cry. It was class if it was real. It was real. And as far as I know, it wasn't Jahak from the pandemic streams. He is banned from the internet. Probably for the next 20 years. His mum, I assume, wasn't especially happy. There's already AI influencers. Yeah, I'm sure there is, yeah. Oh yeah, like that, what's that one that J.D. Bradshaw likes? She's basically AI, isn't she? What are they called? A Vocaloid or something? What's it called? What's she called? Hatsune Miku? What's that called? Andrew told me the word yesterday because we were chatting about it. Hatsune Miku, a Vocaloid, a VTuber, titty twisters, what? Was I right? Vocaloid. Yeah, a Vocaloid. That's what she is. But I am real. I'm the real deal. Just about. So yeah, thank you very much for being here. She's not a sex doll. Fan. 2W. Taylor Juveau. I don't know what that means either. Andrew is not AI. And Andrew is perhaps an example of what happens when AI goes horrifically wrong and glitches out. And I watched a bit of his stream. I love Andrew's streams. I think they're really, really funny. I mean, Andrew's great. Fraser is not AI. I can confirm that nobody in Cultaholic is a robot or AI. He is lovely, isn't he? Isn't he lovely? Isn't he wonderful? Isn't he special? Isn't he? Can't remember the rest. So yeah, we're doing that today. I want to say thank you to somebody whose name I've already forgotten. Let me see if I can find it. Somebody messaged me to say, Adam, be careful. I've watched Ahead with the Armstrongs. There's tits in it. I'm not going to be able to find him now. Where is he? Chris, maybe? That Phil Collins is there. Somebody DM'd me on Instagram. I can't remember who it is, but he said that he wasn't going to be watching this week because he's busy anyway, so he probably won't see this. But thanks if you do. Cheers, person. Because there was tits, I've had to obscure those with a familiar face. It's not Anne's tits. Somebody's showing some sort of magazine or something. I was trying to skip through it because I don't want to ruin it for myself. I want to watch it for the first time. Hi, Adam. If you're not an AI, say one. One. There you go, bonus pizza. So, yeah, I've obscured those. Everything's hunky-dory. It looks like it's the Christmas party episode. It looks like it's going to be a really good one. But as I said, I don't know anything about it. All this talk of being live, I think Adam... What? All this talk of being live, I think Adam might be committing a murder like that gaming streamer. What? Fill me in there. I don't know anything about that. What's that? A gaming streamer... What, and their alibi was they were live the whole time and it was actually a pre-record. Stephen McCullough. He killed his girlfriend. What? I've not even heard of this. Okay, I'm going to have a look. Is this him? He pre-recorded a stream and he killed his girlfriend during it. What an amazing idea. That's a... There he is. Well, he looks... He looks like a wrong'un. Stephen McCullough, a.k.a. Vote Saxon 07, born on 17th of February 1990, is a Northern Irish reviewer known for reviewing various toys and prop replicas, as well as the murder of Natalie McCallie. Fucking hell, the way that they've led with the fact that he did reviews of toys and prop replicas and then went, oh, also, he killed his girlfriend there. It's not funny. It's not funny at all, but what the fuck? In addition to being a former online content editor at the Belfast Telegraph. Wow. No, I've never heard of this bloke. Has he got a lot of... They've not linked to his... I guess his YouTube's been taken down. No, there he is. 35,000 subscribers. Reviewing lightsabers. He's not done anything in 6 months. Lazy. Unbelievable. I think the stream's been re-uploaded. That's fucking mental. What a nutter. I assume, like, if he's being invested, it's quite an easy thing to work out, isn't it? That it was a pre-record. Anyway, moving on from murderers to potential murderers, as I read your very generous donations. Thank you very, very much. Cheers for getting in early. Alex Takeover, obviously. Hello, Adam. Hope everything is good with you and Mr. Happy. Yeah, everything's fine. Everything's all right. Happy looked well in your Insta stories. Well, the reason he looked fine is because I was feeding him shitloads of squirty cream. And he fucking loves it, let me tell you. He doesn't really like being held very much. But if you're feeding him squirty cream, it turns out that he really, really likes that and will tolerate being held. Here in Austria, we have a national holiday today. That means I don't have to leave work early to watch my leader. So let's have a lovely evening up the... And then you got cut off. Up the Austrian national holiday. I assume that was going to say happy Australian... Austrian? Fuck. Austrian national holiday to you. What's that about? What's it for? The 15th of August. If you squirt your cream on whom he loves... Don't sexualize my cat, you fucking weirdo. Jason, thank you very much for the resub, 33 months there. Alex Goddard, thank you very much for 26 months. All right, Adam, glad to be back in the UK for my trip in Poland. Wonderful timing for a cunt stream. Welcome back, Alex. Thank you very much. There was one from JD Bradshaw that's not turned up, but it didn't pop up on Streamlabs, so I've copied it. And I didn't understand a fucking word of it, to be honest. Ahoy hoy, Adam and gang. Hope you're all well. Got that. I understand that. Thank you, Jack. Hope you're well too. By the time you read this, I'll be on a clock to clear my mind and all that, but should be back in time for the second show. Be sure to look after your well-being and all that, chat. So I don't quite understand what that means, but Jack, I hope everything's all right. Nice to hear from you. Enjoy your clock. I don't know, but lovely to hear from you, Jack. Hope you're doing okay, mate. Nice to see your name pop up. Joe New, excited for the show. And what a show it's going to be here in front of two whole doors. NGT, thank you very much. It's nonce o'clock, everyone. Fuck off. Evening, leader. Hope you're well. Looking forward to having you anus power washed. You mean yours? Okay. Looking forward to having your anus power washed. Not on the agenda. Didn't all get an agenda. What are you talking about? I don't know what that means. NJ Starling got kicked out of Collision. But who hasn't? Oh, it's a fucking mess, isn't it? What a fucking shambles. Starling, thank you very much. Vaylock, thank you very much. Armstrong's hype indeed. Thank you very much for your 5 months. Much appreciated. Danger Boy Steve, thank you very much for the gifted sub to the returning Poison. And the unemployed Poison. That makes things all right, doesn't it? You might be out of work for a bit. You'll find something very, very quickly. But more, you can watch ad-free. So take your mind off things, won't it? Thank you, Danger Boy Steve. And sorry again, Poison. Gar Munro, what is my life? After meal with my brother, sister-in-law, and wee nephews, can't think of a better way to end up turning 40 with you bunch of cunts. Happy 40th! That's officially middle-aged. Congratulations, Gar. Perfect gift from them. Hospitality at the football in 2 weeks' time. Prosecco reception, wine with a 5-course meal, padded seating, halftime coffee and snacks, followed by unlimited alcohol for an hour after the match. That sounds wonderful. You have a brilliant time, mate. Happy birthday. Have a good one. Jay Bardi, thank you very much for 14 months. Cheers. Bonus Pizza, thank you very much for your resub that I read earlier. Kelsey Scythe, thank you very much for your 4 months. Hi, leader. Finally submitted my dissertation this week after having to get an extension because of a bad mental health period. The channel and streams, I just snorted at you there. That was a sign of respect. The channel and streams really helped me get through it, so thank you. And all of the guys. Also, happy early birthday too. I hope you're doing okay now, Kelsey. Sending all of our love. Thank you very, very much. And cheers for the kind words as well. Alan Smith, 22. Wagwan Adam was back in Newcastle this weekend for business and some house viewings on the coast. On the coast! On the coast! That's where are you going? Tynemouth? Whitley Bay? One of those fancy, expensive places? Move to Gateshead. Dirt cheap. This place, about 45 quid. Had to get on the metro at Manor Station. It's like something out of an apocalyptic horror film. Still beats Northolt. Manor's isn't especially pleasant, is it? It's the closest station to the office. It's a bit grim around there. It's all being built up. The city centre's basically expanding. And you're sort of between the city centre, which is all right, obviously, and then the hipster bit that... we are not quite in, but very, very close to Ouseburn, it's called. I hope you enjoyed your time in Newcastle, and we're gwan to you too. Berrickson, I still have nothing clever to say here. Hope all is well. That's clever enough for me. Berrickson, lovely to see you. Thank you very much. Cheers. Rolo, hey yo, leader. Hope all is well with you. Any TV or movies you've been watching that you would recommend? What have I been watching? I just watch fucking Crime Watch every night. Watch Crime Watch and Fears, man. What have I been watching? No, there's nothing. I watched half of Jaws the other day. Boring. Went and had a bath. What have I been watching? No, the answer is no. I don't really watch telly. I'm not one of those people that's like, well, I don't really watch telly, actually. I'm not above it or anything. I just like doing my own thing. I've just been playing that Binding of Isaac game non-stop. I've got like 40 wins on it now. It's fucking brilliant. Jaws is brilliant, for fuck's sake. No, that's nostalgia talking. If that came out now, people would just be like, what the fuck is this shit? Dull. Hey, Adam, back from 3 weeks in Toronto. Come back to cunt. Excellent. Welcome back, Chris. Nice to have you here. Cheers. Jaws is better than Travis. Well, Jaws hasn't released 9 groundbreaking albums. They haven't released 9 great... They released 1. 2 at a push. Rolo, thank you very much. LAH, thank you very much. Brand new subscriber there. Welcome, LAH. Lovely to have you here. Have a look around. 2 doors. Dan Lockie, thank you very much for your 18 months. Cheers. Kamazo F, thank you very much for your bits. Hoi, leader. I think I scared you last week talking about chicken fucking. Let me explain. Right. Okay. I don't even remember this, mate. A news anchor in America said that his co-anchor, completely unprompted, live on television. Okay, it's another link. I'm not clicking any more links, but this is, we're doing one.
Keep going on Fox 5 Sky Guardian. And
right, let's have a look, shall we? Let's drag this up. Didn't get notified. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. I always post a video on Instagram, so that's the way to tell. Make sure all notifications... Is Twitch going the way of YouTube? Are they going to start... not pushing notifications out. Whoops! Right, let's try this. What's this?
Click on Fox 5 Sky Guardian and then check that 7 day to make your weekend like plans. It.
Takes a tough man to make a tender forecast, Nick.
I guess that's me.
Keep fucking that chicken.
Okay, I'll do
that. All right, before we continue, the lost symbol has found lots of...
What the fuck?
Keep fucking that chicken.
What? That you can't even... He wasn't even trying to say something else there. It's not like that was a slip... Well, maybe it was a slip.
Continue. The lost symbol has found lots of... Takes a tough man to make a tender forecast, Nick.
I guess that's me.
Keep fucking that chicken.
Keep fucking that chicken. What was he... Not a clue. Not a clue. Way! There's the intro again. And I forgot to turn the other one on. Good. Well, thanks for that, mate. You... Yep. Appreciate it. I've closed my window down by mistake. It's all going to shit. Don't play that again. No, don't play Wife Swap. Calm down. Jesus. Cheers, Kamazo. Not a fucking clue what you're about, mate. Palmo Lord, thank you very much for the bits. Evening leader, beard is looking great. Thank you. Cheers. Hope you and Mr. Happy are as well as you can be. I'm playing at and comparing the Future Collaborations Festival at the Clooney 2 in Newcastle on Saturday, the 26th of August. It's a mix of neurotypical and neurodivergent artists, including my autistic ass. Oh, I hope that goes really well for you. It's a great little venue, that. It's really nice. I like the Clooney. I'm not a massive fan of just going for drinks there, but I've seen a few bands there now. I'm trying to think who I saw. I saw Frightened Rabbit there a couple of months before Scott Hutchison passed away, and it was one of the best gigs I've ever been to because I'd never really heard their music before, bar maybe one or two songs, and it was great. It's a really nice venue. I hope it goes well for you. Enjoy. NGT, aren't you having a colonoscopy? I've been told that the shit you need to drink is disgusting. Where the fuck have you got this from? What? No. No, I'm not. I don't know what wacky rumours flying about. I'm not going in for a colonoscopy. I don't need one as far as I know. Thank you. D's Nuts, thank you very much. All right, Adam. Got my dissertation due Friday. Not started yet, lol. What, are you taking the piss? How many words? 20,000. You're fucked. You are absolutely fucked. Nothing positive that I can say about that. AI, get AI to write it for you. Do it in chunks. You're fucked. You are fucked. What is it? 10,000. You can do 10,000. It's going to be shit though, mate. Yeah. Good luck. Ross240, thank you very much for the bits. Evening, Adam. A delight to be here as always. Was at the Edinburgh Fringe last week and have 2 recommendations for wrestling fans. Mythos Ragnarok, Norse mythology mixed with wrestling, and Chokeslam, a Canadian comics confessional about the ups and downs of her love of sports entertainment. Love the festival, but it's also given me COVID, so swings and roundabouts. Get well soon, obviously. I've not heard of either of those. That sounds wonderful. I've got a few friends that have been there. I've never done it. I'd really, really like to do it. I'll get around to it one of these days. My mate who used to do like Gilbert and Sullivan stuff was up there quite a lot. I don't know if he's been over. He probably was actually. And I've got mates in Edinburgh. I need to get around to doing it. I hope you had fun anyway, mate. It sounds like you did. Liam version one, thank you very much for 8 months. White leader, if you were to do a Tubman in Japan, then where would you want to go for a year? Japan, probably. Next. I don't know. I don't know. Japan's definitely on my list because I like robots and that. I like big flashing lights and all that. Pachinko machines. I think I'd be very much interested in all the really weird tourist stuff. Butlin Skegness, Pachiti in Peru. Yeah, I wouldn't mind doing Peru. Panama. No. Anime girls as well. I love anime girls. That'd be great. Got to see Mount Fuji. Can I come with you? No. Where else would I go? Just somewhere nice for a bit. So, like, Richard had a proper cultural experience. I'm not interested in that. I'm chuffed for Richard. If I go on holiday, I just want to sit by a pool and do absolutely nothing. I wouldn't be biking across all of Japan. Too much hard work. So I would go somewhere sunny, Turkey or something like that, Greece maybe, and lay down quite a lot, and that would be lovely. I could see Hatsune Miku. Is that where she lives? I assume she's Japanese. I've been to Poland before. I love Poland, actually. Great beer. And bonus pizza. Hello, Adam. Can't wait for the colonoscopy street. It's not a thing. It's not a thing, and I don't know why. We're not introducing this at all. I've never been to Dagenham. She's not real, Adam. What? Hatsune Miku. I know she's not real. Everybody's got control of her. This is what I learned, is that she is this thing that anybody can input something to, and then she comes out singing or something. I'm not really sure. I know it's not a real woman. It's an avatar, isn't it? Penzance. I've been to Penzance. Penzance is lovely. I used to live in Cornwall. Great prisons, and I'm not reading that. Been to Colombia. Got cocaine before. Nice. Good. I tell you what, that's something that I've been watching. I watched a few episodes of Banged Up Abroad, or Locked Up Abroad, as it's called, on Disney Plus. And that's very good. I really, really like that program. There's one about Saddam Hussein's son, Uday Hussein, who is dead now, and his body double. And that was a really fascinating one. And it was interesting enough that I thought, you know, I'm going to look into this a little bit more. I don't know anything about the Hussein regime. Not rest in peace. But it turns out this guy, Latif, his name was. Latif Mahir, something like that. The Devil's Double. Yeah, that's the guy. But apparently, according to some journalists, it's all a bunch of fucking bullshit. It's not real. And I'm not going to comment. I'm not going to slander this young man. But apparently, allegedly, reportedly, made the whole thing up. But it's worth watching. It's interesting nonetheless. That Uday Hussein, nasty piece of work. He was horrible. Not up the Hussein, no. And no, I've never met Colonel Gaddafi. Thank you very much. Cheers for all of your... Yeah, down the Hussein. I agree. Beef Latif. What? No, not gone too soon either. We're starting off with wife swap. Fingers crossed this is safe. I'm sure that wife swap doesn't have anything dodgy on it. So I'm fairly confident on this one. And I'm very, very confident on Price is Right. And we'll see how creepy Bruce is. Because last time we watched it, I think it's 2 weeks ago, I fancied some more. I liked Price is Right. He was a little bit handsy. And I know he's a British TV presenter and it's the 90s. But it was awkward. Because everybody loves Bruce as well. Everybody loves him. But he was a bit touchy-feely. A bit much. Happy birthday for this coming Monday. You share your birthday with Keith Hart, Usain Bolt, Bo Burnham, and me, Ash. Happy birthday for Monday as well. I only knew one of those. Bo Burnham. I knew I shared a birthday. It's fucking annoying, actually, because, like, I wish I was Bo Burnham. Because he's so talented, and he achieved so, so much. And he's got the same birthday as me. And for some reason, that just winds me up. You look like Bo Burnham. I don't look like Bo Burnham at all. Get your fucking hands up. He's brilliant. I was listening to that Inside again quite recently. Already, it's very of its time, isn't it? That doesn't happen that often. It's only been, what, 3 years, probably, since-ish that was released? I assume it was 2020, because it was pandemic stuff, wasn't it? It was all about being inside. And it's just weird to listen to now. It's, yeah, a very specific performance. It's great. It's great, but I was listening to it. And I like his earlier stuff, actually. I like, I was listening on the way to Food Bank last week to Channel 5 News and Pandering. Do you know Pandering? About popular mainstream country music. And that's a great song. Really, really good. Yeah, that's right, Peter Brand's country music. That's the one. That's great. He's just very funny. He's very quick. And very handsome. Very tall. Very successful. And very August 21st. I'm going to play the intro now. Should we do that? That's just some children. It's Wife Swap. We're watching... That's the opening thing. We're starting with Wife Swap. Roll the intro. No, it's not my desktop wallpaper. It's the opening thing from the fucking... Yeah, I am going to talk. It's not my desktop wallpaper picture. Of... Idiot. Right, this is what we're watching, this lot here. Loads of them, absolutely loads. Series 9, Episode 8 from 2008. Whoever uploaded this, they've uploaded everyone, by the way, if you're a fan. Old Harry Philby, despite his appearance, is a great stand-up guy. He's a good lad. He's uploaded, right? All of the Wife Swaps. I think all of the Come Dine With Me's, bloody Edwina Curry. Was other stuff. Phone Hacking, Ladette to Lady, Booze Britain. BBC Breakfast from this year, for some reason. He's done loads. Good old Harry Philby. God bless him. Lovely man. Lovely man. Alan Smith, if we all promised to come, would you try stand up? I wouldn't want you to come. I'd want you to laugh. Do you know what I mean? It'd be weird if you're all there. Wamping, you know. Wamping? Wanking? Or, cum joke. No, I don't want to do stand. I did stand up once at university, and it wasn't good. And I still think of it from time to time, and it makes me sad. D. Evans as well. Thank you very, very much. Happy birthday for Monday, Adam. We were born on exactly the same day and year, so I'm 35 on Monday too. No way! What are the odds? Literally a billion to one. Happy birthday, D. Evans. I don't know what the D stands for. David? Donna? Derek? Devons. Thank you very much. Bonus pizza. Choo-choo for Tutu. Rest in peace, Saddam. That's not the way that thing goes, but yeah, all right. Thank you, bonus pizza. It's Desmond. Desmond Evans. Thank you. Cheers. Happy birthday to you, my friend. Let me get my headphones on. I'm not 40, actually. What's that thing where, like, if you're in a room with... Is it, like, 35 people? There's half a chance that you'll have the same birthday as one of them. What is that? That's a thing, isn't it? And it's true, and I can't get my head around that at all. Isn't it bollocks? Bullshit? That doesn't sound true? Wait a second. Is it called, like, the birthday paradox or something? Right, here we go. The birthday problem. It's on Wikipedia, so it's real, right? In probability theory, the birthday problem asks for the probability that in a set of n randomly chosen people, at least two will share a birthday. The birthday paradox refers to the counterintuitive fact that only 23 people are needed for that probability to exceed 50%. There is the maths, if you are into that. Not a fucking clue at all. But you only need 23, that number there, to get to 50.7%. something. How many people are watching now? Apparently the notification's not gone out, so not that many. But there's a good choice. I mean, we've already seen it, right? We've already seen it. Devon's 88 has got not just the same birthday, but the same year as well. So go on, put your birthdays in and your credit card numbers. No, put your birthdays in. April 20, people are just going to repeat, aren't they? Who's got 10th of September, February the 30th, April 11th, two April 11ths, straight in a row right there. The Big Dilf Jawny and Pipeline 89, there wasn't enough time for one to copy t'other. There you go. Any more April 11ths? And that is maths, all right? Welcome, a first time chatter, Jacob Moore getting in on the action. 26th of April, hence the name Jacob Moore, 26. Birthdays, isn't this fun? Bit of maths, bit of learning. So that's a thing, that's a real thing. And everybody went, that's bollocks. If there are 75 people in the room, there's a 99.97 chance that at least one pair will share a birthday. Isn't that mental? It's not bollocks because it's on Wikipedia. The free encyclopedia that anyone can edit. 200 people in a room. There's 99.999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999999 we're all learning together. Not me, I knew it. But there you go. The birthday problem, paradox, whatever it's called. Gabe Horn, thank you. Caught the tail end of Poison's message. It reminds me of the time I was self-employed and got sacked for shagging the boss's daughter. Oh, fuck off. Alright. Between a T, how are you, leader? I'm looking forward to learning about more mathematical theorems in future cunt streams. I can't promise something every week, but maybe when I get back, I'll surprise you all with a little bit more maths. Because it's important, isn't it? You all laugh, right? And you'll go, oh, this is boring, this is shit content. I don't care anymore, you know that. But also, you'll all go into your office, you'll all go into work tomorrow, not Poison, unemployed. You'll all go in tomorrow and be like, have you heard this? 23 people in a room, right? What's the chance that two of them are going to share a birthday? You'll all be on it tomorrow, so don't you fucking give me this shit, all right? I'm not going to tell a soul because they don't care. You will. This will be the title of one of your streams, Pete. Examining the birthday paradox with Consumable Pete. And I'll be watching. NGT. I could explain it to you, but I think I need to be in a voice call. It's kind of simple when you get your head around it. Well, NGT, for obvious reasons, I'm not giving you my mobile number, my Skype address, my Zoom ID, or any other identifying information, because you are NGT 1993. But I appreciate the offer, and thank you very much for the bits. Very, very kind about... what about my Bebo? I don't have a Bebo anymore. I did have a Bebo, of course. Bebo was great. Really like Bebo. Who uses Skype? I've still got Skype. Some people, some meetings, people send Skype IDs, so I've got a Skype account. We have at least two Mexicans in the stream. How about that math? I don't think that's true. Because I can see the demographics, and there's not a great deal from... There might be any Mexicans. Any... It's not racist to ask if people are Mexicans. Yeah, see, we got loads. Olé. See? There's loads. There's shit loads. There's way more than two. Who'd have thunk it? Rey Mysterio. Oh, it's me, Chavo Guerrero. Come on, let's not do this. All right? You have an Aussie. Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. Right, should we watch the program? I don't really fancy watching the programs tonight. I'll get into it in a bit. I'm quite enjoying just chatting away today. Arkham. All right, you sexy bearded Tory cunt. All right, Arkham. Nice to see you. How you doing? Let's just fuck off. Fuck the programs. I'm going to play them. Don't worry. I know it's why you're here. E. At the front there. The little ginger one. Looks like that kid out of the You What Mate meme. You know the one where they're on like BBC Evening News. they're getting interviewed, and they've actually done something really heroic. I can't remember what it is. It's like they've saved somebody's life, or they've donated loads of money for charity or something like that. And then because he looked like that kid in the front, everybody turned him into you what, mate? Horrible. He didn't shoot someone. Let's do it.
Emma Payne lives in Chesterfield with fiancé Lee Hamlin and their 10 children.
The audio Mitchell looks good 16, to me.
Mason 14.
He looks all right, eh? Not bothered.
Jordan 13. Shannon 12. Callum 8. Dylan 6.
Weird surnames. Different dads, I imagine. But how weird that all the dads have got
Ellie 5,
numbers for
Fallon 3.
Fuck me. Months, doesn't end.
4-month-old Charlie.
That is
Working
a big family.
Zendel Ellis lives near Studley with her husband Darren and their two children.
Those were the days, by the way. See the prices on the sweets at Zendel's.
Moya 3 and McCoy
2. Let's not be genuinely classist or shitty, alright? Come on.
Two. Not here for Sam that. Also has a 13-year-old daughter, Ella, who stays with them once a month. The two wives have agreed to swap lifestyles and homes for 2 weeks to see what they can learn about each other's lives. What happens when a career mum has to stay at home to look after 10 children?
10!
I came in and Alfie was on his own and he had that in his mouth.
So why don't you bring it to attention as soon as it happened instead of leaving it to 5 or 6 things? No, this is bullshit, you can shit.
How does a husband...
This is bullshit, you can shit. What a fucking line! This is bullshit. You can shit! Big fan of him. He is a bit Carl Pilkington, isn't he? NGT, we could have an educational Adam hour. You teach us about random things like cows and trains. I have seen a train, by the way. Still not seen a dead person. Alright, I'll keep it in mind. It's a terrible idea, obviously. So, he's just playing with a desktop PC there. Why is that on the windowsill?
Like structure react to a shake-up in the routine.
I'm doing stuff that needs to be done for my family because you're just not Emma, and you're not capable of being Emma.
You've just said...
Go fuck yourself.
I am a guest in your house, and telling me to go F myself in front of all your children must make you really proud.
And what happens when the swap comes to a sudden stop?
He seems horrible.
Emma's coming home today. I said so. If you don't get her, I'll go and get her.
What the fuck?
He's packed it in. Spoiler alert, fucking hell. So, I don't think there's going to be a happy ending on this one.
Is up. Sit down a minute. Lee's called an end to the swap.
Right.
Because he feels that Sam's a lunatic.
Right.
Fuck me. Is it loud enough for you lot?
Yay!
Up a touch,
has
maybe?
Everybody had a wash and brush this?
I'm going to turn it up a touch. Trying to get this right.
Yeah.
That's better.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Emma Payne and Lee Hamlin are full-time parents to 10 children.
Being a mum means everything to me. You get so much love from these kids. Just looking at them and getting a smile and I love you. It's so
it's too
rewarding.
Many.
I'd say I'm a hands-on dad. For example, if everything in this house were left to Emma, she'd have a life of hell, wouldn't she?
A lot of people judge big families. They say that big families are uncontrollable, disrespectful, but until they actually meet one hands-on, they can't.
Mum's a good mum because she, like, plays with us and she's funny and she does stuff with all of us.
Yay! Ellie's turn.
But it's not all fun and games when you're mum and dad to 10 kids.
Buying food for a family of 12 is hectic. We buy probably 20 loaves of bread a week, 8 to 10 pints of milk a day. People are staring at us.
That is fucking mental, isn't it? I quite admire the fact they all sit around the table. That's nice. Keep up the good work, lads. Thank you, Space Badger. Cheers. Jack JD Bradshaw is back. Okay, there's me back from my walk. Realised that I wrote it as clock instead of walk. Didn't understand at all, mate. Couldn't work that out. All the more evidence of how tired I am. Get yourself to bed, Jack. Have an early night, mate. Have an early night. You've done enough. You've done enough. Go and chill out. Nice to see you, mate. Hope you're well.
With 12 people living under one roof, Emma and Lee run their house with structure and discipline.
Someone stop.
Love a stew.
Sneezing.
That looks nice.
The family have set meal times.
Hearty.
Right. Who's been told off at school today, then?
It's like Oliver Twist, this,
and
isn't it?
Everyone mucks in with the chores.
Mum always needs help, and I wash the pots and brush the floor.
Emma had her first child when she was 16. 10 kids later, and at the age of 34, she's hoping to pursue a career.
I'm finding it difficult because I've got 10 children for employers to take me on. Now, if I lied and said I've got two, they'd probably accept me.
But mum of two, Sam Zendel Ellis, has no such problems. She works full-time running her own sweet shop.
How about we go for icy cups? That's normally your favourite.
Yeah. Okay. I think I'm far better as a working mother than I would be as a stay-at-home mother.
Stew is fantastic poison. Good point, well made.
I am not an earth mother. Crafting and drawing and colouring and getting the plasticine out and doing messy play. I do not enjoy that at all.
It's not for you. Don't like her already. Ryan, thank you very much for the resub, mate. Cheers.
Right. Sam and husband Darren are parents to 3-year-old Moya and 2-year-old McCoy. Sam also has another daughter, 13-year-old Ella, who has lived with her father since she was three.
Ella, that's enough.
I don't really often come here anymore. At first it was hard, but now it's just normal.
Because Ella lives with her dad, I have to mentally detach myself from her. I regret completely leaving her with
what?
Her. I would love her to live here with me. She doesn't want to.
In Sam's Zendel...
Got access to the kids, but they don't want to see me. Mentally detached from her daughter. That's... That's awful. That's really fucked. I don't know what to say about that.
Ellis's house, although weekends are family time...
So I'm doing 3 different meals tonight, yeah. Then.
As a working mum who runs her own sweet shop, time is precious. And juggling work and the kids can be an added strain.
All right, stop, you two.
Both Moya and McCoy can be devil children. It's a constant battleground in this house.
Let's do your fleece up.
To grow Sam's business, Darren has put his carpentry work on hold to look after the kids and help out in the shop.
That's sweet.
That's my responsibility. I don't really have a designated role as such, I just do me bit.
But that's not quite how Sam sees it.
I haven't checked my email.
Fucking hell! Why is she beating the mince up? Sorry, it's such a minor thing. She's stirring that like an absolute fucking mad woman there.
But that's not quite how Sam sees it.
I haven't checked my email for 2 days.
Despite putting in a full day's work, when Sam comes home, there's more work.
Generally, most roles in the house are mine. With regards to Darren,
nice.
He is like a fourth.
Two fruit machines, Monopoly, and what looks like Rainbow Riches, but I can't be sure.
Oh, because I do have to accommodate him like I do the children, nagging him to
no,
do
that's deal or no deal, I think that was.
Asking him to do things over and over again.
That's not just me, though.
Well, I don't know.
That's men in general.
I've always wanted a fruit machine. Just as a money box, if nothing else. Put your pound coins in.
To leave home. But when you've got 10 kids, saying goodbye can take some time.
What's he winning? His own money. Some people just like the thrill of it, you know? I'm a sucker for a fruit machine in the pub.
I just hope the new wife looks after my kids.
You're crying already. 10 kids living under the same roof and having to do chores. Didn't realise we were watching Tracy Beaker. I've never seen Tracy Beaker. So I don't know what you're... I don't know what that means. I know it was a bit past my time, wasn't it? When I was growing up. That was sort of while I was starting watching cool stuff like Crime Watch. That was coming about. Tracy Beaker is the GOAT. Yeah, I know it's a big thing for a lot of people. Maybe 5 years younger than me. Turning 30, you probably watch Tracy Beaker if you lived in the UK. Mia, by the way, I can't remember if I said thank you. Thank you very much for the resub. Cheers.
Before they meet their new husbands, Emma and Sam have a chance to explore their new...
Peter, I won £130 on a fruit machine once. I put way more than that in. It's a net loss, for sure. I tell you what I won the other day. You know those machines in the pubs with the scratch cards in them that aren't really scratch cards? You peel the thing off. £15 on one of those. Chuffed.
Holmes.
Oh, it smells lovely.
Not finished decorating there yet.
Two kids, I'd say.
Right, I'm really hoping this is for the jumble sale because it says 0 to 3 months on it. So otherwise it means I'm getting a newborn.
A chilling out.
It was, oh my God, he's got the Big Brother fruit machine. Look at that.
Same room.
Love that.
Where dad plays, I'd say.
There are three beds, so there are...
She's got it all figured out, hasn't she?
...boys in here.
I found receipts for lots of sweets to the owner shop.
We've obviously got a few girls as well now. I haven't found the baby one yet, so we're on to at least six children so far, and I've just seen bunk beds in another room.
Whoa, calm down. You would shit yourself, wouldn't you, walking into that? Nothing against a family. If they want 10 kids, go nuts. But... if you're unprepared for 10 children, that would fucking shit you up.
I'm going to be a shop. We're sweet.
Josh, it's the British version. Look at the teeth.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. There are 10 children in this house. Oh my God, and there's two babies. I don't think I've got the patience for 10 children. I've hardly got the patience for two.
Each wife has left a written manual as a guide to the running of their home.
Right.
In terms of running our house, we run a tight ship. How could we not? Lee and I share most of the chores and the children are very good at doing their bit too. Lee seems quite involved in the housework so far, so he does seem like he's a great help and he doesn't seem like he has to be asked to do things like my husband.
I feel like I do everything in the house and Darren does very little. So she's having to run a business, a house. I don't know how she puts up with him.
Darren, whatever it is, did say that he helps out a lot. He gave up his carpentry for it. We'll see. NGT, remember people, don't be silly, wrap your willy. No, thank you. Yeah, I'm not going to.
The most important thing in my life is my children and my partner. Nothing comes before them. I can think of nothing more rewarding than being a mother surrounded by my children. Ugh. It's the exact opposite of me. Being a mother isn't enough for me.
I also have a daughter Ella, from a previous relationship, but she lives with her dad. I would say that the kids are definitely on par with the shop in terms of my priorities. Oh, my life! How can you say that?
I agree. That's what I was thinking. That obviously, it's great. Like, she's really career-minded. Awesome. But your kids are going to grow up and watch this. And here you say, being a mum's not enough for me. I need more than these two little imps.
So terrible. No wonder daughter's not with her.
Hello. Hi. Nice to meet you. I'm Sam. Hi, Lee. Hello.
My name's
Jane. Okay, you're Ellie, Fallon and Shannon. That's your
partner. I'd never get those names right in 2 weeks.
Hi, Callum.
This is Mason.
Hiya. Mason. Hi, Jordan. Hi, Mitchell.
This is Alfie.
Hello, Alfie.
Hello. This is Charlie.
Beautiful. Hello.
Hello. Hiya. Hiya, I'm Darren. Hiya. Nice to meet you.
Ella.
Nice to meet you.
This is a holiday for her. Oh, they brought flowers and everything.
McCoy.
Hello, darling. I'm Emma. I've got 10 children.
10?
Yes.
Oh, wow.
So, can you imagine what your mum is thinking right now?
God, I'm shocked and I'm not even there. 10 children, God, that's a lot.
No sooner than they've met, Darren is off to his weekly football match.
Right, Daddy's got to go football.
Emma's left to cook dinner for the kids. And unlike in her own home, the children choose what they want to eat.
What would you like on your pasta? Oh, do you like cheese?
Yeah.
Yeah? Will you eat it? Yeah?
good girl.
Cheese and pasta. Solid combo.
Butter on the plate. Yeah. And she'll help herself to the cheese. Yeah. Right.
Wait, what? Pasta and butter with... not melted Haribo. Pasta and... She seems really lovely, this
so
woman, by the way.
And I feel like one right now. After a busy day...
Is that a big thing? I've never had pasta, cheese and butter.
I think Sam would benefit from just making one meal, putting a foot down.
Ah, there's sauce on
she
there.
She really needs to say, right, this is how it's going to be from now on.
Only scrambled eggs.
You don't need scrambled eggs. You'd like scrambled eggs.
Oh, she's good.
Why don't
good.
You try the pasta a bit more?
That's exactly what my mum would have said there. You don't need. You'd like. Look at your eyes.
She's so busy. Darren's got his football and his pool. When does Sam get that break?
That is good mum stuff, right. I agree.
This is it then. You're going to be very brave eating my food. But I'll do my best. All right, wish me luck.
Do you want to just sit and watch TV or whatever?
Sam is facing her first night cooking for 12. But at the Hamlins, it's a team effort.
I like to sort of be spontaneous sometimes and do things like surprise holidays and buying her things. And just... It's nice to just get a reminder that she's appreciated.
My husband doesn't ever do anything like that. It's a real problem in our house because I do so much in our house and I don't remember him ever really doing anything spontaneous like that. It was just really nice to have somebody.
What would I cook for 10 kids? It's got to be something in a pot, hasn't it? Spag bowl's easy to do in bulk, for sure. Spag bowl's an easy one. A bit of fucking massive curry. Stew. She's a great shout with the stew. I've not got a pot big enough for that. Not Haribo. Crock pot? You're never going to get fucking 10 portions in a crock pot, mate. No way. You see the size of those fucking things that she had? It's tough, isn't it? You're quite limited in what you can do because you can't fit everything in the oven. Just a few choice bits. You can't do a... Can't do like a picky tea. Not a picky tea, like turkey dinosaurs and that kind of stuff. You're not going to fit them all in, right?
To help me do...
Yeah, lasagna's a good shout as well.
Lee is completely different to Darren.
Big couple of...
Lee is...
things for it.
Seems to be a very thoughtful person. Seems to be constantly thinking how to make other people happy.
Have you had enough?
With regards to the morning, I'm concerned that it's going to be really chaotic because we're on a tight deadline.
Looks like a different woman, doesn't she?
To get ready there. I'm kind of both excited and scared about what tomorrow is going to bring.
Just the expense of it all. Even if you take fucking... Taking a McDonald's or something. How much is a Happy Meal now? It's got to be like £3 or something, right? More. It was they kept it at £1.99 for a long time, but I know it went up. You know how to make people happy? 9 less children. So expensive to do anything. Imagine a day out for all these kids. Take them to the zoo. It's like a tenner each. Especially now when everything's so fucking expensive.
Working mum of two, Sam Zendel Ellis, is now living traditional mum Emma Hamlin's life, looking after 10 kids.
Are you all right to take that in?
Yeah. God,
you're amazing. I'm keeping you. If it was my life, I would be going to the shop sort of 5-6 days a week. Whereas here, every day is just about children and housework. So let's just go and round up the other troops.
Getting 10 kids up and 7 ready
Good
for
kids,
school
aren't
is an
they?
Easy task.
I think...
But the Hamlins workers...
The 10-kid mum seems like an amazing
okay,
woman.
I've got to do your hair. I'm going to do...
Okay, Sam. Can I go on? Dylan,
have you got yours?
Yeah.
Hello.
This house doesn't seem to have as much of as a routine as I was first led to believe. It is organised chaos, and I think that it would probably be served better if the children had their assigned role.
I don't know Sam that well yet, but I feel I could talk to her and I could have a laugh with her, do you know what I mean? So, you never know, her and Darren could go down on his list of friends.
Could you do a little bit more here for me? Where's Alfie? Okay. Just to check he's all right. So I'd just like to know he's with somebody in a room. Shannon, did you find Alfie? He's in there. Okay, cool. Alfie seems to wander around and I find him in lots of different places on his own a lot. I just went into...
Is that a plug socket cover? It's like a plug, yeah.
Room and he had a dice in his mouth. He's just
a die in his mouth,
he's
actually.
Just prone to so much danger.
Normally, Emma Hamlin's morning involves cooking breakfast for a brood of 10. But as a working mum, it's rush, rush, rush to get off to the sweet shop.
You shut up.
Does she going to have to do the... Oh, she has to do the job now, right? Boy. She's got to go and run come the sweet here, shop for a bit.
Don't swear, babe.
Come here. Have you finished your breakfast? Well, go and eat your breakfast then, please.
I was really disgusted that McCoy just swore and Darren did nothing. Mitchell swore at me once and I chased him around the house with a bar of soap. So I've got 10 children that are controllable. And in this house, it seems like they are getting uncontrollable. They're going to end up having kids that have got asbos.
After a busy morning routine, stay-at-home mum Emma now faces a seven-hour shift in the shop.
Oh, they smell lovely.
They are. Very nice.
Yeah. 88? Yes. Is that okay? I've got to tell Darren what sort of life this is for Sam. She's getting up, doing the breakfast, getting the kids ready for the day.
Thank you very much.
Coming to the shop and Darren's doing what?
Gone the way of the dodo, haven't they, those sweet shops? I've not seen one of those, apart from Beamish, the living museum. I've not seen one in eight. I love that, really love that.
Not a lot by all accounts.
Somebody, some creeper, tea. Check if it's still open. Nice Beamish is great, mate.
So
I think there's one still here in Leicester.
I'd love to sit him down and say, read this.
Looks like a chemist.
Word.
It does. Well, imagine back in the day, if Beamish is anything to go by, they did all sorts of stuff. You'd buy your sweets, but you'd... Everything under one roof sort of thing, right? Still one in Leicester. Yeah, they were chemists. Old school cash register too. It's good, isn't it? It's good. It's a nice, cool looking shop.
And appreciate this woman.
No, I'm not around, Adam. I'd love to, otherwise, mate. Kids,
Sam has a few issues to raise with Lee.
The reason that I need to talk to you is I am getting concerned.
He's got a funny face.
Because I feel that probably because Emma's not here, that he's getting into potentially dangerous situations. I really don't mean this as a criticism. I came in and Alfie was on his own and he had that in his mouth. Okay?
Yeah, so why didn't you tell me then? Or why didn't you just tell me?
You weren't around at the time. I just took it off him. I can't remember. You weren't in the room, but you weren't off. You weren't off sitting.
Hang on a minute, you're criticising me, saying I'm not there with Alfie, no. But you don't know how we're doing. So what time
I'm
of day
not criticising that you weren't there with Alfie.
Yeah, you are. You're criticising me on camera, on my children. No. So
rather than getting defensive...
I'm obviously going to defend myself.
Okay.
You're saying I'm shit dad.
No, not at all. You didn't even let me finish. I'm not saying for a minute that you were off in another room, sat with your feet up. And I know this is hard to take, but please understand I've got to go through this with you because...
But the thing is, if I were busy doing something, Emma would always know where Alfie and Charlie is. Always.
Always put the blame back on her.
Be doing other things in the house that needs.
You're not
to be
shifting
done.
The responsibility of that onto me.
I'm not shifting. No,
I've brought it to your attention. And
gaslighting.
That's not the only thing I need to bring to your attention. That's one of the things that I found.
And that's bullshit. You can shit.
Never in my life have I heard that. I fucking love that. You can shit. Never in my life.
Shove it up your ass. Jess Sunday gets in that fucking car now and gets Emma back. Now.
Fucking hell, he's
can
awful.
Can we talk about it not in front of the kids?
I just don't want to talk to you, Sam.
I thought, why don't you go and have a cup of tea and calm down then?
I'm not going to calm down. This is my house. Don't dare tell me what to do.
I'm asking you to calm down. I'm not trying to patronise you.
Well,
you're
don't. This is my house.
Children. I'm not.
Well,
I don't want to talk about you in front of the kids, so.
He's awful, isn't he?
Really sorry. All right, are you all right?
If things have gone wrong, why haven't you dealt with it? Emma would. So she's clearly, obviously not Emma, is she? But then again, she never could be Emma anyway.
This fucking guy.
No way, shape or form.
All in front of the kids, by the way.
No! After some time out, Lee's calmed down.
Has he?
I'm not going to put any blame on you whatsoever. I were wrong, right, in leaving you with all the kids and to do the things with the kids, right? Okay. And I'm wrong and I apologise. And how you've been with my kids, any dad would be proud to have you as a wife.
Thank you.
I'm sorry.
Oh, me too.
There was some sort of emergency production meeting there. I think he was ready to throw in the towel really fucking early on. And they've had a word and something's gone on there. Because that didn't happen organically. No fucking chance.
The shop might be closed, but according to Sam's manual, Emma's day's not over as she heads home to cook dinner for Darren and the kids.
Hello.
Hiya.
Oh, okay, she was saying he doesn't do anything.
You do rice, because I balls it up every time, basically.
Can I ask you something?
Yeah.
In the manual?
Yes.
The Bible?
Yes.
It says that you never, ever cook. It says that you do not a lot.
Right. Okay. Maybe I do a lot more than she realises.
I'm not saying that you're lying to me.
No,
but
that's fine.
But it's like contradicting things. I'll have to keep checking the manual.
There's a bit of bullshit going on.
Interesting.
He needs to be confronted. He tells me one thing, she tells me another.
Who's doing that sleepy face, Dad?
No one ever wants to hear that they're crap. Never say I'm perfect, not by a long shot, but no one wants to hear they're crap. It's a hard pill to swallow.
Another issue in the manual that Emma's keen to explore is why Ella's lived with her father since she was three.
That's pretty fucking deep to get into. After like 2-3 days, right?
It must have been so hard for your mum to make that decision. But I think she might feel guilty for doing that. In some way.
Yeah, but it affects her very much.
Do you think she's got this active life to stop thinking about emotional stuff?
Not really, because she just has she's always had an energetic life. It's always,
yeah.
It's always been busy. Get up and go, really.
I was talking to Ella earlier on, and she straight away said that she's got a really good bond with her dad. She loves him to bits because he's always been there. And I felt a bit sad because she should still have that bond with Sam.
NGT, hang on, didn't we watch this? Isn't one of the wives an abuser? No, we've not seen this one before. That was a different episode of Wife Swap where that was the case. Cheers, though.
It's the weekend, and Emma Hamlin...
You almost derailed things. Try again, NGT, mate.
Because in my home, I interact with the kids a lot more. In Sam's world, the priority is the shop, then the children, whereas really it needs to be the kids first.
There you are. Thanks very much. See you, bye.
As Emma arrives home to spend a night in, Darren has planned a night out for them both.
Right. Tonight, can't go out because Sam's Bible says Saturday evening, Darren might go to the pub or go to see his friend's band. It's extremely rare that I get to go out with my friends.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, no, I'm just quite hurt by that, actually.
Oh, man. Oh, I don't know who's telling the truth here at all. So it's difficult. But, like, if that's not true and if he is kicking about and spending time with the kids, that would fucking sting, wouldn't it? I was trying to be nice for once. Were you? Keep trying, mate. Keep trying.
Quite actually, because that's nothing that's really pissed me off, to be honest.
Darren was totally disgusted by what Sam's wrote in the manual for a Saturday evening. By all accounts, it's a load of bullshit. Why do you think she's done it, though?
I have no idea at all. If it's that bad and I'm such a lazy fucker and go out all the time and
that
do
are
fuck our
kids
all
are there, mate.
What's she wasted her time?
Effing and Jeffing.
Right.
With the manual in dispute,
this is going
to
break a relationship up, isn't it?
I'm hemmed in on all sides by Darren and the kids, but Darren never offers to take control of things and let me relax. He makes me feel uncomfortable leaving him in charge.
Isn't this manual meant to be like, oh, it's bin day is on a Thursday. It's recycling this week. Not just a big, like, my partner's a fucking useless sack of shit. Like, she's pouring her heart out, and I don't know what's true and what's not. It seems like he's doing a lot, but there are cameras on him, so who knows?
I'd like to know why she feels uncomfortable leaving, what she thinks I can't look after the kids, or... Well, I would like to know what that's all about. They're my kids at the end of the day. She knows full well that I'd fucking walk through broken glass for them. So
yeah.
As for not being able to fucking trust me, like...
One of you is lying, yeah. And I know you.
Yeah.
No, you don't.
And I feel that not everything in there's true. Come here. Come here. Be all right. Go on.
Fuck me, this is heavy.
In my eyes, he's a really nice bloke. He's found out that his wife is now seeing him in a totally different light. It sounds like she just does not like him at all. And what's she doing with him? She's just not happy.
Just thinking, if I'm so shit, why have we wasted all this time? Kids are not the reason to stay together. As much as I love my kids.
Fuck me! Jesus fucking Christ. I should have stuck Bullseye on. Fuck me! This is... Poor bloke. I think? I don't know. This did take a turn. Fucking hell, I had no idea. For the record, I had no idea. Just joined, how's it going? Oh, it's all hunky-dory. It's grand. NGT, where's Wembley? We need to know if the shop's still open. And Jesus Christ, I didn't expect this. London, mate. It's in London. If you Google the name, you might be able to find it. Flappy, thank you very much. The fuck have you put this on for? I didn't fucking realise. We're only about not even halfway through as well. Oh, dear.
Kids, we can't keep making each other's lives a misery for it. My gut feeling is... Is enough's enough.
Fuck!
Let's not waste any more of each other's time.
Shit. Sorry, everyone. I had no fucking clue. It looked like they put him in one of the rooms from Saw as well, didn't they? Thank you very much. A brand new subscriber there in... I don't know how to pronounce this. Flatman. Matman. It's not, I thought it was Roman numerals. Matt Man, thank you very much. Cheers, mate.
Most of Sam's evenings are usually a mix of work and chores, but tonight it's family games at the Hamlins.
Family games. Come on,
says,
feel good.
Simon says
great fun. Play along at home.
Ooh.
Oh, shit, yeah, you got to do it when Simon says. I fucked it, I'm out.
Which one?
Wiggling.
On the one that's on the floor.
I've been much more patient with these children than I am with my own. And I've been having much more fun with these children than I do with my own. And that's making me reflect on some of the things that I'm lacking.
I don't think it was her intention to slag off her kids there, but that came out all wrong. Fuck me. No, I think she's putting the blame on herself. From what I can tell, I think she's going... I'm having fun with these kids, and why am I not doing that with mine? But you phrase that differently, don't you? Kenny, thank you. In hindsight, was wife swap ever a good idea for a show? Yes, it was. It's always going to break up marriages. Marriages, rather. Yes, it is. Yeah. Feel good, cunt. Let's go. I'm trying, Geninator. This is all going to work out in the end. I think the other ones, they should get together. I don't like the baldy man. Not a big fan of her. The other two, as far as I know, they seem pretty lovely, don't they? All good. They divorced. Great. Okay.
In my own family life.
I think Sam's nice and she's, like, she's done good to get to know us.
Don't stalk these people, please.
find out that you're
me that ends up having to deal with that shite, and they send me an angry email.
She's been wanted.
After last night, Darren's been reflecting on his relationship with Sam.
I shaved it off because Sam's always said it makes me look too young, so I've kept it really for that reason, because I've been unsure. But, you know, at the moment, I'm going to do what I'm going to do. No, I'm not shaving my hair off.
He's getting on Tinder or something here, isn't he? He's gonna slap on some brutes and he's gonna go clubbing or something. She's not even back yet. He's off. He's off to flares. Fuck. Even CM Punk's thinking this is a toxic environment. Thank you. Boneless pizza. I genuinely hope Sam's husband leaves her and she never sees her kids again. Fuck. Okay, right. Genuinely feels like we're watching someone who blames her family for all of her own problems. We'll see, won't we? Keep it light. Whoa! What are those? Big handprint on his back. Is that his kid's handprint? That's an unusual tattoo, isn't it? He's got some ink there. I wasn't expecting that.
There's a huge doubt in my mind at the moment. So, yeah, I'm not just going to chuck it in because we'll see what happens from the end of this. Maybe
he does look better without the beard, you know?
Realise that I'm not such a shit person.
Oh, fuck me.
At the Hamlins, Lee's taken son Mason to football training.
Kid's hand that size might have some sort of... Yeah, all right, maybe. I don't know. Maybe it's his nan. I don't know. Ash jamming. I give it 5 minutes until he builds a wardrobe and feels emotion for the first time in a decade. Edgy T. Bet he's wishing he wrapped his willy now and not giving up on his career. Lovely.
Leaving Sam.
Thank you, Edgy T.
Cooking a roast for 12 with keeping an eye on all the kids.
Where are the children? I thought they were going out in the garden. What are you doing, Dylan? Are you sure you're shutting the gate? Come in, please, because there's nobody out here with you. I thought somebody was with you. No, Shannon's gone to the shop. Oh, what am I burning? What's going on?
Casual motorbike in the kitchen. How you do?
Fallon says you're trying to hit her with something.
Chaos, isn't it?
Well, I'm going to be watching out the window now, okay?
Why the fuck? Why has he got that?
You're not doing that.
Holding it by the fucking blade as well. Don't just go, why? Come on, what are you doing? Get the fucking thing off him. Why has he got bolt cutters?
Now, okay? Now, should I do the veg first or the chops? I'm stressed. I'm getting really upset now. This goddamn kitchen, I feel like I'm, you know, from the moment I come in here, I haven't really left. I don't know whether Lee's back yet, so I need to check. This has been a miserable day for me. It's been probably my lowest point. I am getting very tense about this rule change. Not for the children. I think it's going to be great for the children. I just don't believe that Lee is going to be receptive to it. And I think it's affecting everything in me today.
I will I'll have a look out, because we'll do some more wife swap. As mental as this is and as awful and depressing as it is, I'm quite enjoying it still. GS, thank you very much, mate. I'll have a look.
It's rule change day, and both wives are preparing to bring new regimes into their homes.
Do you want to sit with Daddy?
Right. Darren, I feel strongly that you are lovely people, but need guidance to become a lovely family.
What's your name?
It's time for you to see what Sam feels her life is like. So from now on, you will run the shop and I will stay home with the children. Okay?
Okay. You do all do a really good job of helping out in this house.
Yeah.
But it's very sort of hit and miss. And for the next few days...
God, he looks like his dad, doesn't he?
Yeah. So if they don't get done, the only person who you've got to blame is yourself. And I have actually written down a chore list, which we'll look at after.
That's
Ella,
not a bad shout.
Your mum should make more of an effort, spend more one-to-one time with you. So each week, we now have Ella time, where you get to be with your mum alone. How do you feel about that?
That'd be really nice, yeah.
I'm hoping that the new rules that we put in place will contribute to helping an Emma be able to work if she wants to. So as an experiment, I've got a part-time job. Parenting is the hardest job on the face of the earth. I don't know of a harder job. So I've arranged for me and you to just go out. It doesn't have to be for very long, but I want you to do it to see if you enjoy it and to remind you why you work so well together. Is that one all right?
Right.
Oh, good, because I'm really looking forward to that one.
In my house, everyone pulls their weight. In your house, I see chaos, so there's no structure. So from now on, TV is off. And you will have to use your imagination on how else to occupy your children. They'll get used to doing something else then.
Okay.
Smoya, stop winding him up.
I think it'll work for the time, like, yeah, no problem.
He looks like a different bloke, doesn't he? The Sonia and Dee, somebody mentioned, I saw it in the chat, that's the racist one. Is that the one, I'm not going to say the words, obviously, where she comes out and says, like, I thought it was going to smell like. Is it that one? I've only seen the clip of that. I'm assuming that's what it is. Chez, I missed the start. Are all the kids his? He must be completely burnt out, and I'm not just talking about his cock. I think so. I'm pretty sure they are, yeah. Ten of them. What a tosser. Why can you fit a £2 coin between his two? Thank you, mate. Cheers. Thanks for 20 months. Cheers.
As Darren is now doing Sam's role both at home and at work, he gets on with the chores, leaving Emma to be a hands-on mum.
Right then, shall we do a mum coin? Because I gave them a pen and a piece of paper, and they were drawing around my hand, they got so into it. I've had all this one-to-one tonight, and it's probably the most I've had in weeks. I'm so proud of myself for bringing this into this family.
She's a good egg, isn't she?
I needed it.
Britain Wolf, thank you very much. 29 months. Holy shit, time flies. Love you, cunt. Love you too. Thank you very much.
So they know what they're supposed to be doing.
So tidying up Callum and Dylan, they're going to need a bit of supervision with that and a bit of direction, you know, but that is their job. And if you don't see them doing it, you've got to let us know. Obviously, Ellie and Fallon haven't really got anything.
Washing up, drying up, putting away. That's a good job. I'd take that one. Putting away, that's easy. Sweeping downstairs.
But you can always
Wait, what else was there? Clear table after meals. Get breakfasts. What does that say? Gorgeous. Get breakfast gorgeous. I don't know what that says. Tidying up. Washing into dryer. Washing on. Why is that two jobs? What? Oh, it's the same bloke. So, no, it's not. Yeah, it is. So, one person... Sorry. Somebody has to do the washing into basket. And then washing into dryer and washing on. Both Lee's job. Double duty. Youngins. Right, gotcha. NGT, as you want me to be positive, and we all say how fucking good a mum of 10... Can we all say, sorry, how fucking good the mum of 10 is? She's brilliant. She should be something like a nursery teacher. She'd be ace at it. She is. She's really nice. She's like a really nice woman.
And Fallon haven't really got anything, but you can always... I think it's a good idea to try and get him to do a few bits, like pick this up, yeah. Put that in the bin.
I'm very surprised at the rule changes.
The hardest job.
I feel there's been a lot of thought going into it. A lot of positive thought.
You ought to put on one of Jordan's chores as well, getting it bath. Because he thinks it's hard.
let's love each other.
It's a brave set of rules I've put in. But this is a house with 10 children. So I've got to be hugely organised tomorrow, as it's the first day and they're going to be looking to me. So I've got to sleep well and make sure I've got all my wits about me for tomorrow.
We're running late this morning. It's 7:30 already. Sam's still in bed, fast asleep. Mason and Jordan are getting kitchen.
Cracking on with it, good lads.
This rule change is not going to work for very long if I'm doing everything, is it?
We're all late today, aren't we?
But if it becomes a common occurrence, then I shall open my mouth and say something.
See you all later.
See you later.
Bye.
As Darren is now working at the shop, Emma can be a stay-at-home mum, and she's involving the kids in the housework.
You're good at helping, McCoy. Well done.
Moya.
You can't come upstairs.
Why?
Because you can't.
Why? Is it a surprise?
Yeah. I hope I'm bringing structure to the house. The kids
yeah,
have
she's
got
really
down
good.
Loads. Just with me.
Really lovely woman.
For one day. It's so cool.
Can I open now? Wow! Yay, Moya! You're such a good girl!
Yeah.
At the Hamlins, Sam is now up. Under her rules, everyone has specific chores to do. But Lee suddenly decides he needs to go out.
Well, it's 9:30 now.
Yeah, but how far is Sheffield?
About half an hour away.
So how long is it going to take to get ready? I'm trying to get in my head because I can't do a schedule if you're going to be back at dinner.
I swear this woman looks different. Like, she looks like three different women throughout this whole thing.
I'll get back as quick as I can.
Thank you, darling, that's my fault. But I need help from you tonight. So while
Sam,
I'm...
I needed your help this morning, but you were snoozing away in bed. You know what I mean?
It's not even just the hair and the glasses. Her face has changed.
I've got to get stuff done, tough, right?
No, I thought, all right, so first day of the new rules, and your attitude to that is, I'm doing what I want to do regardless.
No, I'm not doing what I've got to do. I'm doing what needs to be done. I'm doing what needs to be done for my family.
Every time we have a conversation or a disagreement, you have to start bellowing.
I'm doing stuff what needs to be done for my family because you're just not Emma. And you're not capable of being Emma.
You've just said that basically you've got tea time. So what, about 7 hours to go to Sheffield to start some paperwork?
Sam, go bow your head, love.
It's the second fucking zinger. He's full of them. You can shit. Go boil your head, love. Boil your head. Is that... Go boil your head, love. Fucking hell.
Real chore. Real chore. Real class.
So I'm sleeping in bed when kids need to be get sorted.
You should have woken me up then, babe. If you were going to use that as a martyr stick, you should have woken me up.
Oh, go fuck yourself.
Babe.
Nice.
Whoa, I missed one though.
A martyr stick. You should have woken me up.
Oh, go fuck yourself.
Nice.
Oh, I didn't quite hear that. Something fucking self.
Babe, if you were going to use that as a martyr stick, you should have woken me up.
Oh, go fuck yourself.
Nice.
It was just go fuck yourself. It was just go fuck yourself.
Don't defend her, Mitch. She's out of house today. Yeah. She's gone.
Do you know what? I really hope that Darren isn't treating your wife the way you're treating me. Because I tell you what, he's far more mature and far more classy to ever speak to somebody like that. No, I am a guest in your house, and telling me to go F myself in front of all your children must make you really proud.
She is only, it's just clicking, isn't it? She didn't know what she had. She's just realised the grass isn't always greener. She's figured it out. Doesn't hate him anymore.
You know what does make me proud? The woman that I've got, not you. It's 9:30. You know what does make me proud? The woman that I've got, not you. It's 9:30 in the morning. I mean, yesterday's clothes, right? I'm running about this morning like an headless chicken to make sure my kid's at school, while she's in bedroom, sat on her lazy ass. That's not taking piss. Come on. Emma's coming home today.
Oh, here we go.
So if you don't get her, I'll go and get her. Take your pick. It's over. Out.
Telling you now.
Whoa.
Out from in the house, Sam.
Lee.
I just want her out of my house. End of. Just get her out of my house.
Tell me why, though.
All in front of the kids. This is fucking mad.
I don't need to tell you why. Just get her out now. Right. This is my house. Right, get her out, mate. Don't, all right, calm down, it's my fucking house. Get her out of my house. No. Fucking get her out of my house. Cameras, out.
He acts like a fucking animal.
It's a different woman again. Who's this? Every time. Bless her, right? She's aged about 50 fucking years during the course of this fucking week and a half. Jesus Christ. He sounds like Johnny Vegas chewing on a bee.
In front of them kids, I haven't got to say goodbye to any of the children now.
Fuck. Never in my life have I seen anything like this. Strength to strength.
Right, who's coming to give me a hand in the kitchen?
They're loving it. Having a whale of a time.
Gonna help?
He's going to change the locks.
He's going to go and play in the garden for a bit. Oh, you want to help Daddy? Yeah. Okie da.
The children are getting a bit more attention and they're more involved. And the family's not here, there and there. They're all as one now.
I hope Santa brings us lots of presents, says Tommy. Cool. And where's the cat?
Reading the children's stories is not something I've done a great deal of. I enjoyed myself.
Where's the dog?
And it was nice for them.
Where's the bunny rabbit? And where's the parrot?
As Darren is looking after Moira and McCoy, Emma has time to spend with Ella.
You said we weren't going to get a feel-good cunt. If you watch half of this, if I trim the other bits out, this would be a really nice little documentary, this.
You're a big sister at home and at this home as well.
Yeah, I'm just everywhere. So how many girls and how many boys have you got?
I've got 4 girls and 6 boys.
Girls outnumbered.
Yeah. She's such a cool kid. She spoke about how she loves doing nails and makeovers and things, but she has to do it with friends because Mum's quite busy. But she's so happy that we've done it tonight.
I'm hoping that my mum will keep that ruling, the one day a week alone with my mum thing, because that's good.
Oh, bless her. Says it all, doesn't it? How many fucking years has she lost as well? That kid's 13 now. She's like a better super nanny. They should have done a show about her. They did do a show about her. It's called Wife Swap. No, she's class, isn't she, mate? She is.
While Sam spends the night in a hotel, Lee has time to calm down and think things through.
I have decided to carry on with Wife Swap. I have decided Sam can come back tomorrow. But if she thinks there's going to be a lot of begging and apologies. I'm going out.
Fantastic. Yes, he is, Chris.
Come on in. I'll take your bag for you. Okay. Do you want to come through to the kitchen? Because I'm just going to sort the breakfast stuff out while we're chatting, if that's all right with you. I do owe you an apology for insulting you.
Sorry, love, you can't shit. Sir, as we said before, if you don't finish the week, we will not pay you. I think that's it. They'll have had some sort of fee for this, won't they? And that very well may be the case. Yeah, there's another frantic production meeting, obviously, that's happened overnight there.
Well, thank you for apologising. But I just want you to understand, I just don't want to get into any more long-winded conversations with you because I am afraid of what's going to happen. And, you know, and that's the honest truth.
If you do decide over the next couple of days, there's things that you do want to get off your chest. I owe you that, to shut my mouth and listen.
Okay.
Right, I owe you that, Sam.
Thank you. I'm dying to see the kids. Honestly, right, well,
can we just...
Obviously, I'm going to approach it all with great trepidation, but I just want to get through one day.
Another different
without,
woman.
You know, some sort of rock or something kicking off.
Go sit down at the table and eat. Sit at the table now, please. You don't walk away when there's food.
In Studley, Emma Hamlin's continuing with her no-nonsense approach to the kids' new routine.
I hear you. McCoy, you are eating some. All right, don't eat it. We have nothing else.
You're staying there until you eat.
No. There you go. No one can seem to take control. No one's showing them the right way. They're just saying, yeah, go do whatever you want. When really, no, the children, they shouldn't be doing what they want. They should be showing boundaries.
Do you like that bacon?
She's spot on, isn't she? One royal storm, can't wait for this fallout. Too right, mate. I think they're going to make it to the table for the wee chat at the end. We'll see. Thank you very much, by the way. Cheers.
We'll try some then, and then you can go out. Good boy! Yay, McCoy!
Positive reinforcement. She's good.
And the rest, that's it. It's lovely, isn't it?
As part of the new rules, working mum Sam has a part-time job at a local newsagent.
Hiya.
That's it.
80 pence, please.
Thank you.
20 pence change.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Cheers.
God, I'm a natural. It's wonderful to be out of that house. It's wonderful to feel like an adult again and a woman, you know, and an individual and not just a mother.
Back home from work, Sam discovers that Lee hasn't done his share of the chores.
The plan was that when we left at 11 o'clock, Lee would be going to the shop to get some shoes for two of the children and get the salad for dinner. I came in here at 3 o'clock. I asked him who was picking up the children. He wasn't sure. And he said that he hadn't got the shoes and he hadn't got the salad.
Oh, shit.
Words useful as a chocolate teapot. That would be from breakfast this morning, then I take it. I haven't been here, so I don't really understand what's happened today.
It didn't make that much sense for her to go and get this part-time job, really, did it? Like, that's just an excuse to get out and not do what she's meant to be doing. I think, anyway. Just a little bit of respite for her. Yeah, not the salad. Yeah, he is exhausting. She's...
Obviously, I didn't expect to come in and find the breakfast stuff there from this morning. For when you come in from dinner time, I wouldn't have thought that would be the norm if you've been at home all day.
You told me not to do washing up.
No, I said that I want the kids to look after things in the evening and when they're at home. The rest of the time, it's up to me and you.
All right.
So...
But the washing up's not my job. My job's the washing and the drying.
No, I think we've got confused then, because I thought I'd made it clear that that's their jobs when they're at home. But obviously, if they've been to school all day and you've been at home all day and Emma's been at home, I wouldn't expect them to clear up from this morning.
I fucking love that you found the loophole. And now he's acting completely befuddled by the whole situation. What a fucking tip. He's not an idiot. I think he knows what he's doing. Obviously, you can't expect the kids to do the washing up before they go to school. He's genuine. And now he's playing dumb. I think he's just been lazy. He's found a loophole, as I say.
So was I not clear about that then?
I'm not wearing this, you know. I'm not wearing being spoke to like a child.
Uh-oh.
I'm not wearing it, Sam.
That's funny because
I'm having to,
you know, you might take it as me speaking to you like a child, yeah? I'm just terrified of any way I say anything to you in any way, shape or form. So I'm sorry.
Can we hear another day?
Oh, here we go. So you here we go again. Straight away.
Right.
You haven't done, you know, I've spoken to you really nicely about those rules. So it just seems to me, it doesn't matter how anybody approaches you, Lee, if you don't like what you're hearing, you're going to find an excuse not to handle it. The latest one is, I'm speaking to you like a child.
Yeah, I really don't know how much I can take of this.
How much you can take of it, yeah, because you've been on the receiving end of lots of abuse, haven't you?
It's stopping, right? It's stopping. I'm going to bog ask it, it's stopping. Kerry!
Give us a kiss. Mwah. Thank you.
She got to say goodbye to the kids.
I've got to go. Can I have a cuddle before I go?
She's been kicked out again.
Mwah. I'll see you later.
No. That's it, no.
Bye, guys.
Oh, that is it.
Bye, darling. See you later. I'm sure later when he's calmed down, he'll stand there and say all the right things in all the right places, but it's just paying lip service because if he was truly sorry, he'd be learning from his mistakes and we wouldn't be here again within 10 minutes of being in the same room as each other.
He's an arsehole, isn't she? She wasn't in the wrong there at all. Was she? Like, what a dick.
He's a selfish, selfish little man.
In Chesterfield, Sam Zendel Ellis has spent a second night at a hotel.
Going into a house of 10 children, I had to either sink or swim. And I actually thought, based on my opinion of myself as a mother, that I would sink very quickly. I haven't sunk, but that has mainly been down to those children. And I'm really gutted that I haven't got to say goodbye, that we didn't get to have our family night. You know, woke up this morning wanting to see them. So, yeah, I think I've really discovered a new side to me.
As well as throwing Sam out, Lee's also insisting that the other side of the swap finishes.
Hi, it's me.
I feel so fucking sorry for her having to go back. I really do.
Are you alright? What's up? What the f*** is up? Yeah, I know. I know what she's like. I so know what she's like. I'm coming. It's all right. I'll not do the table meeting. I'll just come home. That's
oh,
fine.
What?
No problem. Darren, can you come up here a minute, please? Sit down a minute. Lee's called an end to the swap.
Right.
Because he feels that Sam's a lunatic. And for the past 3 days, he's been trying to put an end to it and things.
Okay. Sorry, I don't know what to say.
I feel so shit because things were going so well here. But Sam's, it seems, it could be that I'm wrong, but it seems like Sam's totally fucked it up at my house.
Proper fucking gaslighting. There, obviously, Sam's no fucking angel here. Many faults, but come on. She's taking his word just like that. Horrible.
Yeah.
I'm gutted that I'm going home early, but my priorities are Lee, family and friends. So
I feel so bad for her.
That's where I'm going to be.
Have a safe journey. See you later. Bye. Come on in. Let's go.
Bye.
And what's going to happen here now? Like, fucking 20 minutes ago, he was going... Oh, I don't know if I love my missus anymore. Fuck. Yeah, it feels like the teenage girl, little Matilda or whatever her name is. It feels like they properly bonded. She looked gutted to see her go.
You want your drink then, or what?
You been good?
Hello!
It's Mummy!
Who decided that it was going to be over then?
He did. He's kicked me out. He kicked me out in the street in my pyjamas.
If it wasn't for him, I'd have had a wonderful time. It's hard because right. There's 10 kids, but yeah. He is just unreachable.
I tried my hardest to be nice with the woman. Yeah,
fuck
all
off.
Nice things about her, made her welcome and everything, but every opportunity she wanted in argument, she wanted tussling all the time, she just constantly wanted.
Which is what her husband said.
Her manual is nothing like her house.
Right.
And I think that I really tried to be honest about in the manual.
I had some bits in that manual has really, really broke me.
In what way broke you?
In some of the things and what you think about me and that, and it's just been really hard, and it's something we need to talk about. But to be honest,
I don't think there's anything that I haven't said to you.
It sounded like I was an absolutely lazy pig who'd done nothing. And
but there's nothing in that manual I haven't said to you. Well, I don't mean, after what I've been through the last week, I don't really think that that's fair to bring that up to me at the moment.
Well, I do, because I think it needs to be said.
Well, I don't think it needs to be said at the moment.
Right, well, that's your opinion once again. No, see, no, this is it. I think if you genuinely thought what you've written in that manual is what you think about me, then I don't see why we're together anymore. Because
oh, fucking hell.
I've just lived with a man I've told you that's been abusive all week, and what you're now concerned about is how you feel.
It's a month on.
What a horrible episode.
Back to normal at the Hamlins.
All in front of the fucking kids as well. Phil. I made her feel welcome, told her to eat shit, even to boil her head. What more could she want?
I think since the
Thank
swap,
you, mate.
I've realised what I've got. I see...
That is a man who should not grow his hair out. Everyone except for the woman on the right here has changed so much. Al's toy barn. Fucking Al's toy barn. Oh, That's so good. Oh.
My life is being how I want it to be.
Oh, no.
We never went into swap because we got problems, you know. We didn't have any problems. We were happy with just us. But I think all it's done is made things stronger for us.
But there are changes for Emma as a stay-at-home mum.
I'm now doing a midwifery course.
Nice. Oh, she'll be amazing.
I've got lots of experience in that field, obviously.
One thing I've realised is that me and Emma need to spend time just me and Emma. We need to be Lee and Emma as well as mum and dad.
The swap has also had an impact at the Zendel Ellis's.
Oh dear. Place your bets.
Despite whatever flaws we have in our relationship, we want to make it work and we want to be the best sort of team the that we can be, really. Do you agree with that?
Yeah.
No.
No, I would, yeah. But we still got things we got to work on, but yeah.
Ready? Steady.
Having enjoyed being a mum of 10, Sam's outlook on parenting has changed.
If I push you too hard, you'll fall off. My attitude in respect of Ella and the impatience I had with Moira McCoy since I've been back from the swap has been considerably different. I kind of made a decision while I was away that I would make a lot more effort with Ella when I got back.
My relationship's improved quite a lot with my mum.
This is good.
We talk a lot more about things. But before we might have been a bit more quieter and stuff.
One of the things I did get from living with Lee, it did make me reflect on the nice qualities in Darren, particularly how much effort he puts into our relationship and his role as a father.
The fact that Sam now appreciates me a bit more is a good thing, I suppose. It's about time, to be honest.
Go on.
Sort of happy ending there.
Really fast.
I'm going to click the link in a second. Doopy Leo, here's an update about Sam and Darren. It's the same one, right? We went on wife swap to make our marriage stronger. Instead, it's torn us apart. Distraught mum, we went on wife swap to make her marriage stronger, has accused the show of wrecking it. Samantha Zendel Ellis and her husband Darren had come through 6 tough years together with 20 grand in debt adding to the strain. They wanted to show how love can triumph over adversity and hope cash from appearing on TV would ease their burden. Now they're getting a divorce. Well, it's not the biggest surprise, is it, I guess? Producers created the drama just to make good TV. Now they've ruined our marriage. I was told them. Fuck me. Dear, oh dear. I can't be asked to read all of this. Everybody happy? Are we all feeling good? Is everybody having a good time? Well, the Al's Toy Barn comment got a laugh. So well done. I can't even remember who said that. I didn't see the username. That was the saving grace. That was a rough fucking watch, that. Should we watch old Bruce Forsyth try and touch some women? Let's give it a go. Thank you, Loopy, by the way. Cheers. Oh, this can't go wrong, can it? It's only a quick one. Oh, fuck off. Every fucking time. I don't know what year this is from.
Here we go. It's Britain's brightest game show.
Mid to late 90s, by the looks of it. Right. Will know by the prizes. What do you mean? Welcome, smallest horse, by the way. Cheers. That pose is iconic. He's got the catchphrases, he's got the pose. Talked about it before. He's got the lot. He's got the wandering hands.
And it's always nice to meet the stars of our show, whoever you are. Michelle Lester! Come on!
Right, he's got his target. First one out. Who else we got?
Behabod, come on down! Michelle Cookson!
I don't know which one he's going to go for. Not a clue. We've seen this one. We haven't seen this one. We've only watched one before. He wasn't 30 here. Boneless, fuck me. Thank you very much, Boneless Pizza. 5 gifted subs. Thank you ever so much. Congratulations to DL Drago, to Just Matt Liv, to Nobby's Nuts, to Alex, and to the famous Warrior 22. Thank you so much, Boneless Pizza. That's really, really kind of you. Thank you. Cheers. And left hand down, Andy Pipkin, come on down. Andy Pipkin, I know that name. Oh, you... I know that. So thank you, cheers. Thanks for the resub. Oh, he's going to like that. Wait, what happened there? Right. That is a shirt. Beautiful.
Bruce's Price is Right. All right, nice to meet you. What a lovely young thing you are, my darling.
Straight in there. What a lovely young thing you are, my darling.
Meet Uncle Bruce.
It's just a... Have that one more time. Uncle Bruce.
The lovely young thing you are, my darling. Meet Uncle Bruce.
Hiya.
Don't be like that. Okay. And where are you from?
I'm from Leicestershire.
Leicester, with all the Leicestershire people. Marvellous, marvellous. And Bod. Bod what?
It's actually Beirut, the first name.
Oh, Berry?
Beirut.
A Beirut? And you call yourself Bod for short?
Yeah.
Well, I suppose it makes sense, but welcome. Welcome. And you, when you jumped up, do you know your tank top nearly came off?
Oh, Bruce! Beloved British entertainer. This was on telly every week. Just him... No!
Oh, there we are.
Oh.
Right, lovely to meet you. And this shirt, it really is. That's brightened my whole day. It really has. Where did you buy that shirt?
Marple in Cheshire.
I thought so. Got a bit of cheese going down each side, hasn't it? Anyway, welcome all of you. Okay, it's bidding time. Who's going to win this?
A Punction Judy machine.
Oh.
Based on the old penny flipping machines popular in the end of the Pier arcades, the idea of this game is to get the coin past Judy. It's in a varnished...
I love that.
...and finished in shiny chrome.
I've got a rough idea of how much these go for. Because stuff like this pops up on my Facebook Marketplace. I'm always looking at like arcade machine. I've not got one or anything. But I love shit like this. Old British seaside tat. Very... You're way off. You're way off with your 200 quid. Way off. I think back then you're probably looking at close to a grand. The ones that I see go for about 800 quid. Now. This is a replica, isn't it? So it's based off of. So... I'll play a bit lower, I reckon 600 quid.
It's the way to do it. Punch. There we are. Okay, now we're going to start off with you, Michelle. So what do you think?
250.
No, surely not.
Bob.
Up.
200.
200. Okay, Bob, thank you. Michelle. All right, Michelle.
220. 220.
That's a stupid guess.
Michelle.
She's useless.
And Murray.
Up. Just go 300. Play it safe.
255.
Yeah, clever.
Okay, well, the actual price we were looking for is 200.
No!
25. It's Michelle.
Oh, my God. I just slagged her off and she's bloody done it. I'd snap that up. 225 quid. Bargain.
Yeah.
Well, they've clearly rocketed in value.
All right, my dad. Now,
hands where we can see him, Bruce.
Please be gentle with me. All right, my darling. Anyway, you won the Punch and Judy machine. Ditch the weed, ditch the weed. And how would you like to win,
sure,
Michelle, this? A fun and funky compact car.
Nice.
Yes, wherever you're going, you'll love getting there in this cheery little three-door hatchback with a useful
8 grand. CCs under. Looks quite nice.
It includes central locking and a stereo system, and you can drive.
Wanna wear this original from Uncle Bruce? No, no, no. Right. Thank you, Gar. 7,950.
The price of this car is a four-figure sum, and no number is repeated. First of all, I give you 7 one-pound coins. Keep them there and count them. Make sure there's seven there. Good? Mm-hmm. You've got lovely, lovely. Right, now I want you to give me the first number in the price of the car. If you're right, you keep all seven.
People are going a bit lower. If you're wrong, you give me a pound. I don't know anything about the price of cars.
Out. All right, then? If you're wrong. Do you understand? So think about it. The first...
A few people going with seven there, though.
Seven.
Nice.
Seven?
Everybody happy with the seven? Okay, Simon, is it? Is it? Is it? Yeah.
Go on, look at this. Good start. Good start.
They were very good.
It's a really tough game, this. Seven over or under. But you got... It's the last digits that are the hardest ones to get, isn't it?
Seven now, then. The next number.
7,950 is my guess.
You're going, most of them were saying four. Let's see if most of them are right. Is it a four? Is it a four? No, ooh, a two.
That's all right, though.
But
2 quid.
You only have to give me two. It leaves you five left you've got, which is very good. Right, now then, the next number in the price of the car. What is it?
Nine.
You're going with a nine? You're not sure, are you?
No.
Oh, you're going with a nine. Is it a nine, Kimberly? Is it a nine? Is it...
Oh, bloody hell. She's going to win the car here. Goodness. Well, one would assume that it's going to end in a zero or a five, right? So she might be safe. If you go five, she's got the 5 quid. Does that work?
You're on a roll. You've still got five.
I guess it could be a nine. No, no, because no repeats. No repeats. Go five. Surely it won't end with... A non-zero or a five?
A five?
Five? I think she's got it.
But is it a five? Is it...
Spot on, look at that. What a woman.
Just a moment. Just a moment.
Didn't need a touch of there, but
give
go on.
Pound. The car is yours. Okay, now run over there. Don't go away too far because you'll be in the showcase showdown, which is coming up later on. There we are. Right.
Good start.
A space left. A space left. Who's going to fill that space? Terry O'Sullivan. Come on down. What happened? Your watch come off, did it?
It did.
Eh?
It fell off. Do you want to put it back on again?
No, it's all right. Well, whatever you feel comfortable. We want you to all be happy here. Here's Bob, Michelle, the little thing at the end there, and Murray here.
Michelle, the little thing at the end. That little insignificant mollusk at the end. Fuck me.
All right, then, but don't get too friendly with them because only one of you can win this.
It's a boombox. If you like your music massive, then this CD radio...
I don't know what they were. They used to do those in the Argos catalogue. 250? See, maybe it's a bit cheap. 350. I'll go 350. JVC. It's not an amazing brand, is it? You reckon cheaper?
110.
Nah, fair. They're going low.
120, Bruce. 120.
It's 120, right? 1 quid. Michelle, my darling. 170.
Murray playing like a total cunt here, by the way.
149.
Sorry. Okay, well, the actual price we were looking for is 179.
Hey! That lovely little thing's done it.
Come to uncle.
One more time, just in case you missed that. Come to uncle. Come to uncle.
It's the Michelle show. With the sound of it, all right? But anyway, the boom box is yours, but how would you like to win one of these?
a superior music system, and a skin-tingling scooter.
Always wanted one of those with the CD on the front. The glass doors open on your that's classy. Radio
and a CD player that can list 100 titles. The attractive ultra-modern speakers sound as good as they look.
Beautiful.
Scooters are the new motorbikes, apparently, and the updated styling of this dream machine, added to the new technical features and the improved 50cc engine, means you'll be king of the road. And one of these fabulous prizes could
Do we just have to guess which is which? I think swap them. Right. I think the CD player is cheaper than the scooter. Is that all you got to do?
Now, let's have a look at this hi-fi system here. 2,150, that is the bargain price, not the actual price, okay? What we want you to find out is which one of these two items is the
What do you reckon?
Bargain, that's what you're trying to find out. Okay, over there, the motor scooter.
That hand
here
is...
We are, £1,395, that is the bargain price, not the actual price, okay? Now, which one is the biggest... bargain.
Oh, is it the biggest saving?
What all your friends say?
The scooter.
The scooter.
Yeah, it's got to be.
The scooter? Everybody's for the scooter. All right, then. Well, we'll start with this one first, right?
The system... Look, watch the fucking fingers, right? Because he's not just holding her inappropriately. Watch his little fucking claw.
All right, then. Well, we'll start with this one first, right?
See? He's giving her a fucking tickle.
£2,150.
So uncomfortable. Agreed.
The actual price is... £2,350, making a difference of £200.
That's not ideal, is it? That's a lot cheaper than I thought it'd be.
So that means if the difference between the bargain price and the actual price is more than £200 for the scooter... that will be a winner for you, if it's more. So, the bargain price is £1,395.
Shudder.
The actual price is... £1,795.
She's done it.
Making a difference of...
Just about. You are a winner. Bruce is fucking buzzing, now, Uncle Bruce.
You can choose now your prize. What would you prefer, the scooter or the wonderful system?
Scooter.
All right, then. Well, the scooter is all yours, and we'll see you later for the Showcase Showdown, and that goes for you too. Wave, darling. Wave. Back. Just one more. One more person is going to come up for this show tonight. Now, who is it? Jill Ellis. Come on.
Way too old for Bruce, it's fine. Oh, wait, no, she's not even that old. Sorry. Yeah. Oh, God. That's an elderly lady because of the hair. It's fine. No, he's keen. It's fine.
Jill, you nearly went over, didn't you, dear? You nearly came down here on your chin. Where are you from?
Liverpool.
Oh, from Liverpool. And is it Jill with just one L?
No,
you couldn't afford the other L. Oh, you've got two L's. What happened to your other one? Probably fell off as you were coming down here. All right. Say hello to Bod. Isn't he a big Bod? But concentrate, Jill. This is serious. Okay, it's bidding time.
A football table game. This is a full-height, arcade-quality football table with two teams...
They're about a grand now.
...running steel bars and a fast-moving...
I've got a mate who's got one. So I think he paid about 900 quid. Back then,
right,
550.
Okay, Jill, with one L. Make me a bid on that, darling.
280.
280? 280.
I'm way off on these, aren't I? I'm not doing very well at all.
350. 350. Terry.
395.
Watch this end bloke be a twat again. 400.
400.
Fucking told you, he's a wanker and he's still not. I hope he doesn't win this. I hope it's fucking dead on 395. I like Terry. Bruce has taken too much Cialis this episode.
The actual prize we were looking for is 495.
There you go. Oh, I wasn't that far off, but I went over.
You can see it in all its grandeur, but the football, you're dressed for it as well. You're dressed for a football match. Okay, but how would you like to win this, Murray?
A looker of a cooker. Cook Cooking is a pleasure when you're at the business end of this kitchen range in modern streamlined Croke.
Couldn't fit that
the
in my kitchen.
The top includes a large
That's a beast, isn't it?
And underneath, there are two ovens and a storage area for bakingware. And we're throwing in a set of pans so you can start cooking right away.
Here we are. Beautiful oven.
You may prefer this.
A Christmas shopping trip to London. That.
Oh, you London?
You'll travel by train from wherever...
The way he said that. You'll travel by train? That's great. Fucking brilliant. Okay. How much cash? Christmas shopping.
You'll stay for two nights in a top hotel with views of the Houses of Parliament. We're including a flight on the London Eye, so you can really enjoy the sights, the lights, and the nights of the capital in its favourite season.
No spending money. Two nights in a hotel.
No spending money? Gotta have spending money. 500 quid, give me... You mean thing. 500 quid. Higher. £500 spending money. Don't listen to them. Listen to me. I'm the governor here. Right. Now then, don't let them too carried away. You've got to win it first. You're going to play high-low, OK? All these are own brand products, OK? We want you to pick
Oh, I like this one.
Highest-priced products.
Three highest-priced products. What's that? Is that potpourri or something? Dishwasher tablets? I don't know what that is either. Suntan lotion. Suntan lotion's not cheap, is it? Instant coffee's cheap. Laundry detergent, I assume? I don't know what that second one is. I guess they'll
and
tell
then
us.
You'll be a winner. So, listen first of all very carefully, everybody.
50 dishwasher tabs and one pack of potpourri.
I don't know how much potpourri
480
is.
Tea bags.
Oh, that's quite a lot of tea bags.
Of body lotion. 300 grams of coffee and 2 liters of fabric conditioner.
There we are.
Dishwasher tablets, I would definitely put in the most expensive category. That is a lot of tea bags, but their own brand. Dishwasher tablets, potpourri, and the body lotion, I reckon. What do you think? Potpourri is like £3. My dad used to sell potpourri down the markets. So I should know that, but I don't. Lou Markham, thank you very much, mate. Nice to see you. Thank you for the resub. What do you reckon? Fabric conditioner and coffee. No, I put coffee right at the bottom. That size as well. I think the tea's going to be more expensive than the coffee, given that there are, 480 bags. Body lotion. A lot of people are saying coffee. We'll see. We'll see.
The three highest priced products.
The dishwasher tablets, Bruce.
The dishwasher tablets, you think? The dishwasher tablets, right? Let's have a look, see what they are.
Yeah. $4.97. That's a lot of money.
Pretty good, I would say. Pretty good indeed. Now another one. We want three.
Yeah. Dad was a market trader growing up, and he used to sell. He just called them smellies, and I can't really remember. I was so young at the time, but I used to go down the. I used to go down the market and help him out. Or there was a on Sandown Pier on the Isle of Wight. There was a little market on a Saturday, and he would take me along, give me £2 to play on the arcade machines, and then we'd go to McDonald's afterwards.
The coffee, Bruce.
The coffee.
Really?
The coffee. Yeah, the coffee. The coffee. All right, the coffee. Let's have a look. Let's have a look. The coffee.
That's more than I thought it would be. You know.
Good as well to me. Now one more we need.
There's a lot of tea bags.
Tea bags. Right, the tea bags.
Yeah, he's an amazing dad. Great guy.
They're 480 tea bags.
Nice. Yeah. He's done well here.
This looks very good indeed. Let's take these two away and get the lowest one. Now, each one of the three that are left have got to be
that potpourri though.
48 for you to be a winner. So first of all. The soft apricot potpourri is $1.99.
Dirt cheap.
Good.
Very good. Terrifying.
Okay. Now then, the, what is it? Moisturizing body lotion. Oh, it's not the one I use. Anyway.
I think that could, if it is lower that could be higher. Oh, he's done well. He's done very well.
Now the last one. Okay, the fabric conditioner, as long as it is lower than 348,
$2.49.
You are a winner, you can either add the cooker or have that lovely trip. It'll be up to you, but is this lower than 348?
Yeah, look at that, dirt cheap. He's done well.
A winner all the way. Now choose whatever you want to do, okay?
I think I'll have the trip to London and the £500, please.
Yeah, fine. You can have a wonderful Christmas shopping trip. Look forward to it. You've got all the year to look forward to it. Now you will join Michelle and Michelle, the Michelle sisters, and the Showcase Showdown. Come along.
Everybody wins tonight. We needed this. We needed this after all of the drama and misery of Wife Swap. I'm quite happy with this. As long as Bruce keeps his hands to himself, we're in for a good time here.
In you go, marvellous. All right, then. Murray, in you go there. That's lovely. Right. Now, then, let me remind you, if you score 100 with one spin or a combination of two spins, you will win on the spot, no questions asked, £1,000 in cash. There it is. There it is. All for yours. OK, now, come in here, Michelle, my sweetheart, and lift up here. You know all about the wheel. Lift up as high as you can and give it a real good tug. Give it a tug. That's it. Oh, my God. She's all there, isn't she?
Oh, oh any excuse. Right, creepy now, little fuck. No. 85's all right, though. No.
You're going to spin again, yes? You've got to spin again, yes? You don't have to say please. You're entitled to another spin. Go on, give it another 30. A 70 could be... Oh, the 70 that's gone. But a 55 would be... An 85 would be too much.
Oh, 30. 60.
That gives you 60. You
could not ideal.
60. You never know with the wheel. The wheel can do some funny things. OK, Murray, give it a good go. That's it, lovely. OK, Murray, now 60 to beat, up to yet. Let's see what's on the wheel. A 70's coming up. And now,
oh, 80 would be nice,
wait
no.
Wait a minute, oh, now ooh. It won't reach. 75.
Good start.
Up to you.
Bank it.
You in the lead. Yes.
Stick.
You're gonna stick. OK, over there you go. Sorry about that, Michelle. Now in you come, Michelle. Here she is. Here she is. Give it a go, my darling. Give it a go. Don't break it. That's it. Good. OK, Michelle. 75 to beat. 75 to beat. It could be a...
Oh, 90 would be good.
Could be...
No.
No, no. A 70. Oh.
Oh.
Well, spin because a 75 is in the lead. So away you go. You need...
Bruce is going to be fucking gutted.
A 10 would be marvellous. And a 5 would be a tie. So you need a very low number. Now, 30's gone. Is there a...
Ah, oh, fucked it.
Oh, sorry. No.
No? Why are they all cheering? Gave a false hope there. Bruce looks fucking livid. 70 plus 60. She's done it.
Oh, you're cheering for the other fella. What a mean lot. What a terrible lot they are.
Fucking shoves her away. I don't want Bruce to win here because I think he was being a bit of a scoundrel with his initial guesses. Like, it got him to the final. It's got him a trip to London, 500 quid cash, 2 nights in a hotel, train journey, lovely. But he was being a bit of a bastard, wasn't he? I don't want him. I'm not sure. Murray, did I say Bruce? Sorry, Murray.
About the range finder. Okay, now the bigger amount you get here, the bigger chance you have of winning. So get your hand ready. Wait till you feel an urge coming on, Murray. Cool, look at his eyes. Right.
Yeah, look at his eyes.
The urge is there. Press down on your plunger.
Ooh, that's rough.
2,000, but that's not impossible. You can be £2,000 under, but not one penny over. So, Murray, you're going to see some beautiful prizes. Beautiful prizes indeed. We want you to give each one a price, then total them up at the end. Murray, this is your showcase.
And your showcase tonight, Murray, starts with this fabulous rock guitar that's bound
what
to
is it?
A collector's item. It's fully authenticated and signed by three members of The Who.
Ooh, okay. Signed by The Who. It looked like it. Is it a Gibson? I don't know a lot about.
And signed by three members of The Who.
We'll have a guitar nut in.
And Pete Townsend.
Pete Townsend. Wrong'un. Is it a Gibson Les Paul?
And you can be on your way to fame and fortune too with this, your own rock band. The lineup features electronic drum machine, 5-piece drum kit with cymbals, computerized multi-sound keyboards, 6-string electric guitar and...
Why does he want two guitars? What a fucking weird... Okay. Oof. Those electric drum kits back in the day were expensive.
Amplifiers, in fact, everything you need to hit the charts. And how about...
It's not Travis.
...in Brazil!
That's right, isn't it?
Splendid luxury in a first-class hotel with its own private beach. Only a short drive from the fabulous Copacabana nightlife. And so you can enjoy it to the full, we're giving you £500 spending money as well. Home again, and you'll find this waiting for you.
Fucking hell.
Cobra two-door.
Wow. The fuck?
Breathtaking 6 seconds.
Was not expecting that.
In the boot and inside, the seats are plush leather and the dashboard is English walnut.
That's beautiful, isn't it? That's amazing. Not a clue what it's worth. I'm going to take a punt at 33 grand. All in. Because that car's got to be pricey. 33, I'm locking it in.
But there you are, maybe your friends can help you, but your friends, there's a lot of other people trying to help you. You've got to make up your own mind.
We're getting 25 from up there and 22.
Oh, they're going way lower.
25, you're going with 25.
I think he's going home.
All your friends are for 25.
Without the big prizes.
Murray's bid is £25,000.
I'd say higher.
You could be as much as £2,000.
I've been shit today.
It didn't give you much to play with, but you can't be one penny over. What is the price of tonight's showcase?
Oh fuck me! He was so close, but he was 500 odd quid over. That's gotta hurt.
Only by £547, you miss it. Just by £547.
Oh, what a fucking downgrade, by the way. If you stay tuned, you can watch Joe Pasquale's Price is Right.
That was one of our closest.
Oh, dear.
That's a great shame, Murray. A great shame. But you did win the football table and the Christmas shopping. Have a wonderful time with your Christmas shopping in London. Plus your £500 is not what we wanted for you. A total of £1,995. So thank you for being so good about it. But only 500 quid out here.
And on behalf all right, you're not paid to talk.
Simon and Kimberly, Leah and Emma, remember no matter what happens, Bruce's price... unfortunately, sometimes it's always right. Good night now, and thank you for being with me.
Cheers, Bruce. Thank you. Well, there you go. Uncle Bruce is done for the day. Right, we've got one more show to do. You all know what it is. It is the favourite that I now have to boot off my desktop because I had to Sergeant Pachiti it up. We are finishing off with episode 4 of The Armstrongs. So make yourselves comfortable. Thank you once again, by the way, for your support. All feels like a bit of a routine, this, doesn't it now? As far as, like, I just sit here, second program's done. Thank you, thank you. I really, really mean it. We're all very, very appreciative of your support. And thanks for watching us on Twitch and wherever else, obviously, as well. Appreciate you all. Thank you for your views, your eyes. Piss flaps indeed, Mr. TJD. Cheers. So yeah, this is the last episode of The Armstrongs for a couple of weeks. I've never seen your videos before. What do you make? Oh, all sorts of stuff. Mainly ones about CM Punk at the moment. Well, for the last 8 years. Let's do it! Trying to ride the audio here. It's a fucking mess, this program. Can you bring back the beanie on the Cultaholic shop, please? I didn't even know it was out of stock, mate. Yeah, I'll have a chat with our guy. See what we can do there. Winter is approaching, eh? And what a summer it's been.
10 years ago, John Armstrong met Anne, and it was an instant attraction. Joining forces in marriage and business, they set out to become multimillionaires. Together, they've built UFIT, Coventry's third largest double glazing company. But like any organization, UFIT's continued success depends on the people working within it. And as Christmas approaches, the sales team's figures are not looking good.
Shocker.
Press you totally and get the call stats. And Dan was saying he's only had 11 people to call. And I know for a fact that one of the ones that Dan made outbound was to order his food.
Amazing start. 11 today, I assume that is, in one day. Is the Othello guy still there? He is. He is. How's the wacky training going? The training's going very, very well. He's an inspiring, inspiring man. I don't think any of them have gained anything from the 2 and a bit grand training.
Stairs. Lucas said he's only had 16 to call out of a database of 1,700. And Rebecca was saying that she's only had 14 to call out of a database of...
Oh, I don't know. Now is the time for action. Now is the wind of our discontent.
There we go.
I tell you one thing I'm thinking of.
What?
Well, Napoleon's army, right?
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Called his Imperial Guard. Mm. And they were like 5,000 of them. They're the best of everything. They were the best warriors. They never fought any battles, though, until they're absolutely needed. But they said that each one of them was worth 5 normal troops. Well, that's what we need, an Imperial Guard.
Brilliant. What are you going to do? What are you fucking going to do to get them?
I'll place an advert right away.
Wanted. Must have served as an Imperial Guard in Napoleon's army.
One thing I really admire about this bloke is that he always tries, and it's not necessarily a good trait or anything, but I can relate to it, I guess, is that he tries to make a joke out of everything, and he always tries to make light of the situation, which is fucking annoying in a lot of these cases. But I don't know, there's something about him I actually find quite likeable. They're both fucking useless, goes without saying. But I don't know, I quite like this bloke.
Although training will be given.
Bring home the uniform. Mm.
Something's going to happen, I'll tell you. Something's going to give. Something's brewing.
On his last,
it is why Brent was likable.
John and Anne,
oh, here we go.
Zimbabwean business guru Basil Meany recommended the sacking of the entire UFIT sales force.
You guys haven't a clue. I can tell you that right now.
I can't stand Basil.
They just haven't fallen over. That's the problem. Yeah. You can't have a company survive with that kind of attitude in there. I'll tell you something now, I'd fire the whole bloody lot.
What that Basil was saying was a load of bullshit. He's just chatting shit. Because I knew what he was going to say.
Hey, how are you? All right.
Fuck me. If looks could kill. What a greeting. Wow.
John's hoping that a reality check from Basil will energize the sales team in the lead up to the busy Christmas period.
Forgive me, but from Africa we speak very slight. If you're not prepared to do what you're supposed to do, you don't deserve to be here. See, no company can ever go anywhere without the correct people making the sales. And if you're not making the sales, then you guys at fault. Totally. Totally. There is no excuse, there is no reason, there's nothing. You've got to look at yourself and say, what am I doing? You know, the other day I was sat inside the room there and I was listening to guys making phone calls, and do you know what? In 40 minutes, one guy made a couple of calls. Nobody else made any calls. Nothing. Just never made a single call in 40 minutes. You got lists of names to phone. Oh, you were fiddling with a computer. Fiddling around.
He hates him, doesn't he? They all do. I think part of the reason that he's employed old Basil, got him to come in, is because Basil is now doing the job that he doesn't feel fit to do, I guess, because he doesn't speak to them like this, does he? He's not down to earth with them. I don't like Basil, as I say, but it takes the pressure off of him a little bit.
Piper, that looked hanging impressive, but at the end of the day, the job wasn't really being done. Okay.
I couldn't do it on the computer.
Don't make excuses as to why you can't get on the phone. I don't know how you feel, but for me personally, as an individual, I would actually be embarrassed. I actually feel a little bit like, hey, hold on, yeah, man. You know, wait a minute, I've got this stuff and I really need to be doing something with it. Jeez.
Because it's not really his job, is it? He's come in now and he's managing the company rather than, I guess he's a consultant and all that, but is this his responsibility to be, I don't know. Geraldine, thank you ever so much. Cheers for the gifted subs and congratulations to Liam, to Ghost Out and to Feed LJR. Geraldine, thank you very, very much, my friend. Cheers.
Right now, and if I were you, I would be milking it for every cent I could. I tell you what, I would go mad right now.
Encapsulate and refine down. I know it's difficult, but I want to put 10 seconds worth of dynamite in there. So when anyone's ever feeling down, because you've done this good, I want them to be able to press the little button, get a shot up there, and then that mental picture to come back. If we speak really loud, clear, get that enthusiasm, let it flow like a really loud...
The fuck happened? What's happened with her head? She doesn't normally look like that. She looks like someone off of fucking Mars Attacks. What's gone on? It's not... She doesn't look like that. Is it just... Have they stretched her out in post or something? What's going on there?
Yeah, let it flow like a river.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never, never, never give up.
Okay.
Right, let's have a play.
Come on, Basil, say it for me.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be.
Great for morale.
Never,
they'll
never,
love that.
Never give up.
Got the energy inside it. That's good.
Right, somebody's phoned up.
Yeah.
Somebody called Dave, asking if we've got any sales jobs going.
Mm-hmm.
What do you want me to do?
Get him in.
Okay.
Sometimes an individual can make the difference. Look at Julius Caesar. Hannibal, not Lecter, but Hannibal the commander. He made a difference, didn't he? Defeated the Romans. And he was an individual. Well, this bloke could be the same, and we've got to get him here to listen to him, see what he's got to say. See?
Okay.
You tell him it's an introductory interview. Okay, we want to find out a bit about...
This is the new team leader guy, isn't it, that they talked about last week?
What makes you tick?
Yeah, I'll phone him now.
Hello, is that Dave? Oh, sorry, someone's given me your number, but I think it's the wrong one, mate. Well, I'm just sorry about that.
Let's see if he wants a sales job.
What? It fucking says it all. Amazing. Lauren, thank you very much. Evening, Adam. Your recent stories with Mr. Happy make my heart melt. Hope you're both well. Thank you. Cheers. He's a lovely little boy. That was weird. Make sure you have the best birthday and time off. Much love. Much love to you as well. Thank you very much, Lauren. Cheers. I will provide more Mr. Happy whenever possible.
See if he wants a sales job.
No, he don't sound right. You know what I mean? The way he answered the phone.
What do you mean he doesn't sound right?
Didn't sound... Telephone manner weren't very good.
Was that him?
Yeah.
How can you possibly prejudge something?
Wait,
like
that was the right guy! And because of the way he's... Oh my god! I thought he genuinely had the wrong number. He got the right number. He didn't like the way that he answered the phone. Fuck me. Oh my god. Adam Jonesio, thank you very much. White Wank Chops. The vid of you and Happy and Cream was so wholesome. Look at this back-to-back happy goodness. Probably made me smile. Can I be cheeky and ask if you'd share my Just Giving page, either here or in Discord, as I'm doing a run this Sunday for charity. Insert appropriate rhyme here. Yeah, whack it in, mate. Whack it in the thing. I don't know what happens with... I think the links come through. You're more than welcome to chuck it in the chat, mate. Of course you can. And Yeah, the links do come through, in fact, because I get the YouTube links and stuff through. Yeah, be my guest, my friend.
No, that's why he said it.
Fucking hell.
Unimpressed by John's recruitment technique,
YouTube.
Anne's
fuck
taking
off,
matters
Pete.
Into her own hands.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never, never, never give up.
Mental.
I interviewed some people and I've actually taken on somebody who Andy has already interviewed while I was away. And he had a few.
I don't know where the dog is. There's a dog there. It's not the dog.
Gut feeling and all that. And he tends to be one of these.
Yeah, that dog's disappeared.
He said, you talk to him and see what you think. Well, I just thought completely the opposite. I thought he's a young person, basically. He's about 19, 20 years old. But he's got 2 years' experience in this industry, but in a very hard sell way. Not in this namby-pamby, oh, I'll phone you back in 3 years' time then, I don't want to bother you. I know while we were away, you interviewed that young lad, didn't you? And you said to come back.
To do business, you couldn't fucking write it, and he's blowing a feather across the table with a straw, large straw made out of A4 paper. Fantastic. Brent was genuinely a better manager than John and a better motivator than Basil. I think I agree, which is saying something, mate, isn't it?
Me, but you had reservations about him, didn't you?
Yes.
I invited him in on Tuesday and I had a really, really long chat with him.
Just the lad with spiky hair?
Yeah.
And, yeah?
Yeah.
Looks like Duran Duran region.
Yeah, he does actually. And I actually think he'd be very, very, very good. In fact, I think he'd be so good at giving him the job. I mean, we can get references and everything, but he has been used to running teams. Well, how about we have him as team leader? Because let's face it, the team that we've got are going to be mightily annoyed anyway when we introduce new people. So if we're going to have him as team leader...
I don't know how to pin your comment. I was trying... What was that? Oh, it's my headphones. My headphones are running out of battery. It'll be all right. Sorry, something just spoke in my ear just as I paused it. I don't know how to pin your thing, but if you're feeling generous, then Adam Jones EO's Just Giving is in the chat right there.
Leader. We might as well say he's team leader from day one.
Right.
Interestingly enough, he used to work with Michael.
Don't trust him. Don't trust him. And I can throw him quite a distance, so no, I don't trust him.
It's a small world, isn't it? They hate him.
He's 19 years old, and he knows everything about everything. And his humour's got a bit of a dark side, I think, and I don't really appreciate it. It rubs me up the wrong way sometimes. And that's about as much as I know about the guy.
Oh dear. No, not old Othello rivals. Hey, nice. You fit in. That's quite good.
With the Christmas break just days away, John and Anne are planning to invite the staff for festive drinks at the soon-to-be-opened company bar.
Rum and coke!
White wine for me!
There's a definite lead shortage right now. That's the way it seems to me. And they're looking to take someone else on. So... That says just one thing to me, and that means they're looking to get rid of people.
When they change something, if you don't like it, you know, just leave. So, we know the choices. Just we've got to make one.
Merry Christmas! I want to see this new bloke.
Monday,
I think we saw a clip of him last time.
As usual, just expecting the last week to be quiet and totally uneventful. Dan, he turned round and handed me a piece of paper before I'd even opened my mouth and said, don't know whether this makes any difference. And I opened the piece of paper and it was his resignation. I sort of sat there stunned, really.
Thank fuck it's not Michael. I can do without Dan. That's not a problem. Michael's still with us. Well, in the show, he's gone. We've lost
but
one.
Obviously, we've got to now escort you from the premises. I said it's nothing personal. It's just the way that we have to do things, and that was fine. Michael was sat at his desk. Luke was at his desk, and Rebecca was stood by Luke. And she got this piece of paper all folded up in her hands, sort of like this, rolled into a tube. And I went in and I said, oh, hello. And Luke said, Rebecca doesn't know how to tell you, but she wants to leave as well.
Fuck.
Women's intuition, I don't know. I went to the sales office door, flung the door open.
Not Michael.
Quite tongue-in-cheek.
Not Michael.
Right, before I go to the expense of reallocating these leads, are you two staying or are you going? And Michael said, well, I'm staying.
Yes! Okay,
that's one. And Luke turned around and said, well, actually, I've got another job as well.
It's a mass walkout. They've lost three of them. All they've got left is Michael! Oh, no! Yes! It's the Michael show now! Fantastic. Amazing.
They were like a house of cards, weren't they, John? Once one went, they all started. What did you liken them to this morning? Lemmings.
Guys, you are where you are because that's where you've chosen to be. Never give up.
Amazing.
I'm stunned, yes. I mean, you're bound to be. You've just lost 3/4 of your sales team. But you've...
Look at him on his own. They brought the fucking motivational speaker in and they've lost 3/4 of their sales staff. Michael is a star. They can't have the main attraction leave. He might be better than Jenkins. What? Better than Mark Jenkins? He's up there, isn't he, to be fair?
And I'm just thinking now, what a great opportunity we've got. We have got the one person who is left. Is, let's face it, he's the one person who, since he's been here, we have never had to talk to about his timekeeping. Not once. Every time we look through that door at Michael, he's on the phone, isn't he, John?
Yeah.
He's on the phone.
Go on. What a guy. What a guy.
Every time we go in there...
So he's doing his job?
Yeah.
And he's getting results, so there's a fucking surprise.
With sole access...
Look at those figures as well. That one day shifted 3,812 conservatories. Next day, more than double it, 8,645. Bit of a shit day on the last one, but he still managed to shift 3,461 conservatories. That's what those numbers mean for sure. Rebecca, 626. Awful.
Leads. Michael's results have improved
significantly. 9,000. He's actually doing fucking amazing here, isn't he? Fair fucks.
I was doing something right. Maybe now I wasn't selling as spectacularly as Luke or Dan, but... I'm here. They're not.
Supposedly got somebody starting. Ryan is starting in January. And he offered to be team leader. So, I hope he works well on his
bit of too shy.
Anne's called Ryan in to meet John and what's left of the UFIT sales team.
Michael.
Rockstar. He looks like he's happy using the phone, so that's a good start. He's already streets ahead than three people.
Huge entrance. So this is the guy who's like, what do they say? He's like 1920 or something. What's this soundtrack? I think it's that one.
A lot of excitement. A lot of changes already. Yeah, you see, you leave me alone for... couple of days and it all changes. Right, come on in. Now, I'd like to introduce you to your sales team. That is it.
The look over the shoulders got me. Oh my god.
I've got lots to tell you.
That's fine. Bit of a challenge for me.
Come on through. Right. Here's Ryan.
Oh, yeah.
This is John. That's my husband.
No, it's my girlfriend's magazine.
Oh.
I'll pull out on page 30.
So it's a woman with her breasts out here, right? I didn't look into the context of this. All I was told that at the beginning of the second part, which I've joined into the first part, there's something for Sergeant Pachiti. There's Sergeant Pachiti. I think he's brought porn to work on his first day. I said that like, why don't you wait until the fifth day at least, mate? He's brought porn to work, I think is what's gone on. And he said, this is my girlfriend. A bold move indeed, famous warrior. Let's skip back.
No, it's my girlfriend's magazine.
Oh.
I'll pull out on page 33 and
1, 2.
Aww. Aww. Really
aww.
Oh,
she is.
Lovely.
What's her name?
Danny.
They were fully out.
I've been on page 3, haven't I, John, of the Coventry Evening Telegraph?
Mm-hmm.
Basically, you were going to come in.
It's just fucking batshit, isn't it? You'd show him the door immediately. This is your new team leader, and he's brought a fucking jazz mag along with him. Mental.
Basically, you were going to come in as team leader, and that was how you were going to be introduced from the first day. And then all of a sudden, we haven't got a team. How do you feel about that? Are you still happy to come in January knowing that you haven't got...
Good time of the year, actually, January. I'd say every time of the year is good.
Yeah, John's not keen at all.
So is that how we're going to do it?
Okay. Yes.
You've already worked with Michael anyway. Yeah. I don't know whether you wanted to spend half an hour
just to get a... An rough idea, isn't it?
Yeah, and hear how he's approaching his calls and stuff like that. But he's on 29,000 or something now for this week, so...
On his own. Well, did Michael work with the terrier?
I know.
He's really good.
Yeah.
Trained by...
He did a full-on fucking David Brent there! He did a full-on fucking David... Trained by... That was... Complete Brent. Trained by.
I know.
He's really good.
Yeah.
Trained by.
The lip bite and everything.
Michael is unaware that Ryan's been offered the job of team leader.
You show me what you do then, Mike, and I'll just sit and watch. Just come here now. I'd like you to show me something totally outrageous.
Okay.
Show you something outrageous. Well, outrageous. I thought it was quite outrageous that you're wearing a fleece underneath your shirt. Just the other way around.
What's wrong with that?
For the fact.
That is odd. To be fair, you do you. If he doesn't know that he's the team leader and he's talking to him like this as well, he's got a fleece on under his dress shirt. Right. Don't get rid of Michael. If this fucking clown.
I've had words with you about this before, haven't I, Mike?
The fashion
without
police.
Sounding nasty.
The fashion police.
Yeah.
Is he serious?
You wearing odd socks?
Yeah.
Yeah. I want to hear your speakerphone. I want to hear the customer. I want to hear your reaction.
He's a fucking cretin. I fucking cannot stand him. He's awful. If this fucking idiot gets rid of Michael, I'll be so annoyed. He's a fucking pleb.
I want to hear the customer. I want to hear your reaction.
They can't fucking see his odd socks. He's on the phone.
It's not an assessment, you know.
No, it is for me, because I just want to listen and see how you've grown.
As far as I'm the same guy as when I worked for
enhanced.
If you like, yeah.
What did you think of my first impressions?
If I was forming a boy band, him and two others, what does it matter? I mean, I think what we've proved here,
is that
we can take anything and anyone and make them sell. It's a bit like changing thunder into electricity. It just happens.
Thank you, then.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye, then.
Well, that was brilliant, wasn't it?
Do you think so?
Yeah. What's going on? Really good, mate. Well done.
You reckon?
Yeah.
I'm getting encouragement from all sides now. It gives me a warm feeling, right?
I do the whole package. I'm not fussy, to be honest. I mean, it's about making money, isn't it? He's quite a critical market. Do you know why? He doesn't like it. He didn't like me telling him what to do because I'm relatively a younger age to Michael.
I don't mind that because that's history, but you haven't actually stopped. Which, you know, you're not actually my boss anymore.
Well, I could be.
Good luck.
So, we'll see.
Tomorrow's the day.
If he doesn't get the job, I hope they fucking sack it off before January comes around. Like, that's the word. Like, he hasn't even started yet, and he's gone in there and he's literally just bullied Michael. He's making the sale. What a cunt.
When we finish for Christmas, and I'm really, really looking forward to that.
I think John, I'm looking at John now, they look a bit like Wayne Rooney. With glasses, an older version of Wayne Rooney. No offence, Wayne, but...
I'm actually looking forward to having the bar all stocked up and, you know, being able to pour drinks for people. That'll be quite nice. That's if anyone comes. But we can have a drink anyway, can't we, John?
I should think so.
But I am so looking forward to next year. I really am. Because I just think when we've had this little break at Christmas, it'd be nice to come back. New year, new challenges. We can just move on now.
It's a good point. Blinky do. Adam, if the porn mag didn't deter them, nothing will. That should have been the fucking end of it right there. Right, you've brought a copy of Razzle along and you haven't started yet. There's the door. Sorry, we've got to escort you out. It's the procedure. Just fucking hell. Oh.
All the fucking tossers that have previously worked here, Merry Christmas. Please don't ever get in touch with me ever again. Thank you.
Christmas party time. Lovely.
So we brought the CD player in as well to play some Christmas music.
Yeah, it smells like Battenberg cake.
Trying to...
She's all glammed up.
...the top off the bottle so that we can actually sterilise it. Because the idea is we're going to fill it with beer and put it through the water cooler.
We've got to sterilise this as well. Right away.
Yeah. It smells quite clean anyway. Right. I'm not very good with measurements here.
Yeah, I'll give it here.
You've got to read the instructions. If you don't make it strong
enough, it won't
work.
I know what I'm fucking doing. I use this, you know.
I know, but they'll all be dead and then you'll be complaining. Well done, John.
What the fuck are they... I get that they're trying to... Are they making beer?
There's about...
What did they used to shout in olden days before they did stuff out the window?
I don't understand what's going on there. Irate Knight, thank you very much. The arrogance to try and put your only sales partner down when he hasn't even started yet. Surprised I haven't seen him on The Apprentice. Too right, mate. Yeah, he just seemed like a horrible fucking little cunt.
I think...
Oh, they're here.
You know, it's like... They try and do things professional, but it's just not, it doesn't work. So there's no point trying, I don't think. So it'd be good for me in January to actually work for a professional company.
I'm in the mood for Christmas.
Wait, are they emptying the bottles of Beck's into the water cooler? Is that the idea here?
The beers that the guy who supplies a glass for us, he brought in a few crates of beer for the lads. I think
gotcha.
John will probably pass them out to them. Oh, that's,
yeah.
That's a Christmas band, isn't it?
Stingy fucker.
Won't it all just go flat immediately and go warm very quickly? As well, I mean, they're not. I don't think they're cold anyway, are they? It's just going to be a warm, flat beer. Yeah, that is what's happening. Okay, just to clarify, all good.
Christmas.
Yeah, well, I was doing a better job than you.
It's a good visual. Water cooler full of beer.
Of
fuck me.
We're going to do a raffle as well today. Look, let me raffle.
Look.
Was that gravy?
Look, let me...
Great. Yeah. Fuck it. It might be the booby prize. It's all right. You want some fucking gravy.
You wrap them in the spirit of what they're given.
They're going to be so excited.
They're all gag prizes. Amazing.
Paper off.
How much did we spend on all of these, do you think?
About £32.
Christmas is lovely, isn't it? Can't we give it?
Weight Watchers. What was it, lasagna or beef casserole or something?
And you want to give them more? You know, we've got the reputation not being a giving company anyway, so why go and ruin it?
Look how much. This is a flashback to, I guess, the Christmas special, which was like what kicked this whole thing off. Look how much they've given up as far as like their appearance here goes. He's there, UFIT branded shirt and tie. She's looking like Maggie Thatcher. Now, different world. Is this how the Cultaholic Christmas party typically goes down? Yes, yeah, it is. But we put mulled wine in the water cooler. Makes way more sense.
Give him. You know, like, what's his name? That old geezer, Mahatma Gandhi. Yeah, that's who you'll be.
You're an arsehole. Look, that is going to be dangerous because by the time we give that to somebody, it's going to be half defrosted.
Ah, fuck them. Yeah, let's put some tape down that one.
Look at the fucking state of it. They've gone... I don't want to say they've gone all out because they've got a water cooler filled with fucking Bex, but the bar and everything, it's kind of cute, isn't it? They must have built that out of conservatory bits as well, window frames. Oh my god.
All the factory lads, bet they weren't there. Straight out, gone where they're going.
Yep, spot on. Oh no, it's just going to be Michael, isn't it? It's not even Michael. Who are these?
He just walks around doing fuck all yeah. day. He's just a fucking arsehole. Yeah. He's an arsehole.
Yeah, no, he didn't help us at all, did he?
What, they didn't give a shit about anyone in there.
Wow. Everyone's going to phone in sick. All hungover. I bet they did it on a like weekday, on a Wednesday night or something. No? Bright and early, of course. He's got himself a new outfit. He's got himself... I think that's a different coat that's way too large for him. I think that, I'm sure that's not the one that he had on originally. He's fine.
At UFIT, Michael's returning to work.
He's looking nifty as well. Nice haircut. Himself. He's looking good.
It's actually quite a conservative new look. It's shoes and trousers and a shirt. And the shirt has actually had a passing acquaintance with an iron this morning. I feel like an extra in Saturday Night Fever or something.
Do, 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 do. Oh, I really like him. He's changed, hasn't he? He's grown. See how shiny his shoes were. He looks fantastic. At the beginning, he was just a bit of a punchline. But now he's come out of his shell. I just think he's a sound fella. He's great. Rest in peace, Big Mike, indeed.
To get a paycheck of, what is it, £1,300? That's far and away the biggest paycheck I've ever earned for a week's work. And it's worth
it. Oh, good for him. They do commission then.
Back, you know, what you can. Because, you know, I'd like to be here in a year's time. Apparently, Ryan's starting work today. This is the rumour that I've heard. It's no sign of him as yet.
Oh, no. He's calling in, isn't he? He's got a different job. He's not coming. Good.
It's Ryan. Oh, brilliant.
Yeah, he's not coming. I'm chuffed
just
with that.
Just a text, John. Yeah. Do you know, this place is cursed. Mm. And I've been offered my old job back last night. It's a £30,000 a year job. I'm really sorry to let you down. I was so looking forward to working with you.
Good.
But it's too... That's
too.
It.
But it's too
shit.
Shit. Fantastic. I'm chuffed with that. Didn't deserve it anyway. Promote Michael to team leader. Michael can team lead himself. Good. Chuffed with that.
But he's done us a favour.
Tosser. I know, but it's just all the time. You think, you know, we're honest enough to turn round to people and tell them what we think, aren't we?
The world's full of fucking messes, surely as sparks fly upwards from the fires.
Why do they all come here, though? We have had a steady stream of idiots come through this door and call themselves bloody salespeople. Mm. Well, it stops now. Never, ever again. If anybody comes through that door saying, I'm a salesperson for so-and-so, they'll go down those stairs bloody quicker.
Great. Yep, yeah, good outlook. Back to bed. Are they going to be in bed together? One of those weird... No, even weirder. No. No! That's the most contrived fucking shot I've ever seen, by the way. No fucking way. Outrageously staged. Outrageously so, but I think we know where this is going. It's Michael's. Biggest plot twist. What are we looking for? Just a plus. Wait. What does that mean? Pregnant's a cross. She's got some dark piss. Needs to drink more. Oh no, there's a faint line there, isn't there? Jeez. Yeah.
I think we're having a baby.
We.
Smart again, doesn't he?
Yeah.
I feel very proud of him.
We are the makers of men.
So what we're thinking of doing is can take you and your wife out.
What strengths do you think are his biggest?
Size of my willy.
Oh. Why are you hiding? You've done something with the sales, haven't you?
They do that.
Who's
as well.
The sales manager?
Michael. You are there to work through the database until people either tell you to fuck off or they buy.
And where we're at, Michael, is your clarity of information
is crap.
Oh,
yeah,
what?
The highway or the fucking highway. That's what I'm telling you.
It's all over the fucking shop, this, isn't it? It went from them taking Michael and his missus away for a lovely romantic meal. And then all of a sudden, My Way or the Highway. What a show. And she's bloody pregnant as well. With maybe Michael's baby. Bonkers. You got to wait 2 weeks. I've not eaten. I've got to go and make myself some dinner. I've got to take the bins out. Got to fill Mr. Happy's mouth with squirty cream. Behave. And yeah, that's it. That's it from me. So I'll see you in a couple of weeks. All the best, everybody. I'll see you when I'm back. Much appreciated, everyone. Take care, and I will see you next Tuesday. Except I won't be. You can call me a cunt anyway. Take care. All the best. God bless. Good night. Bye. 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 Bye.